This is a production of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, made possible by the Friends of SDPB. Pledge your support for quality programming. Call Friends at 800-333-0789 or donate online at sdpb.org. You may purchase this video and many others online at our website. Click on Shop SDPB. And thank you.
This high school activities championship event is conducted under the auspices of the South Dakota High School Activities Association.
And good evening, South Dakota. For Steve Toome from South Dakota Public Broadcasting and Craig Maddock from Sioux Falls Sports Radio, KWSN, I'm Mike Henriksen from SportsMax Radio and Calling All Sports. Welcome to the capital of football in South Dakota, the Dakota Dome in Vermilion. We wrap up three very hectic days with the 11 AAA championship game coming up tonight. So great to have you along in the booth with Craig Maddock. Craig, these are two teams you're very familiar with. We'll get more in depth on them shortly, but this should be a heck of a game tonight.
They are the two best teams in 11 AAA. They've been one or two all season long. And it's pretty fitting that they're going to meet again here for the championship. They didn't meet back in early September. It was a wild one. Lincoln won it, but we'll tell you more about that game as the night rolls on.
Meanwhile, you will see a new starting quarterback for the Sioux Falls Lincoln Patriots as you get a look at Lincoln. Connor Burchill, their longtime starter the last 2 years. He injured a knee in his last playoff game. Isaiah Roach will be getting the start instead. And again, we'll tell you more about that. But in case you missed it from last night, the 11 AA championship was held as the Peer Governors came to town for the first time in 25 years, taking on the Watertown Arrows. And Craig, if you didn't see the first half, you didn't see the game. Alex Gray hits Austin Christofferson on the touchdown there. Peer was rolling early. And then the handoff goes to Case for the touchdown. He barely gets in. However, on the ensuing kickoff, it was Shea Bratlin. Watch this.
Ran away from everybody.
He is one of the best in the state, and he showed it there. But alas, that would be the only touchdown on the night for the Watertown Arrows. They were able to effectively bottle him up, was the Peer defense. Here's an outstanding pass, number two. This one also goes to Christofferson, who will go into the end zone. The Bratlin last night held to just 90 yards on 20 rushes. There, Case takes it himself. He was already into the end zone and with the score. It was 34-7 at halftime. There's the throw. There's the pick by Garrett Pocup. Now, the interesting thing there is Pocup is one of the best soccer players in the state. So he specializes in a sport where he can't use his hands, but by golly, he knew what to do with the football last night. He grabs it and takes it into the end zone. 34-7 was the halftime score. Peer played a near-perfect first half, and there was no scoring in the second half. Again, Shea Bratlin, an outstanding running back, but the Peer defense really held him down nicely last night. So we'll be back to talk to the coaches to take a closer look at tonight's game. Oh, there you see West Central. Let's go ahead and look through these. West Central with a last-second win as they win on a pass to defeat previously undefeated Madison.
That's their 12th championship.
And Madison, a heck of a year, still nothing to hang their heads about, as that's one of the best Madison teams in history. Canton in 11B, they came from behind to defeat Parkston. 20-14 was the final there. Parkston with a chance towards the end, but could not recover an onside kick. Canton was able to hold on, run out the clock. Gabe Dolan, an outstanding game.
That's their third title.
Meanwhile, Bridgewater Emory Ethan, speaking of multiple titles, they had very little trouble with a very good Arlington team. There you see Wade Miller, 24 rushes. Craig, this Potter County game is just tough to describe, isn't it?
That was the first game on Thursday, and Chase Hall did something that no other South Dakota quarterback has done in South Dakota playoff history for the championships. In 32 years, he passed for more than 460 yards, 8 touchdowns. In fact, he broke the record of Chase Marceau of, 454 yards passing last year.
And it was a very entertaining game. Remember, those two teams had played each other earlier, and it was 12-7, so this was different.
They both got better, didn't they?
And yes, they did. And then in 9B, Avon also came from behind and also won on a pass in the last minute as they pick up the victory. Congratulations to Todd Culver and the crew. Also a great year for Hamlin once again as they suffer their first loss of the season. Fans are settling into the Dakota Dome in Vermilion. We hope you are settling in next to your television, your iPad, on your phone, as we've had some people watching these games. We'd love to hear from you here at sdpb.org. We're going to be back to preview tonight's game for you right after this timeout. It's the South Dakota Class 11 AAA Championships on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Sports Championship is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank.
With Craig Maddock from Sioux Falls Sports Radio, KWSN, I'm Mike Henriksen from SportsMax and Calling All Sports. The Roosevelt Rough Riders taking on the Lincoln Patriots. Steve Toom from South Dakota Public Broadcasting will be joining us later as you get a look at the Sioux Falls Lincoln Patriots.
Mike, just their second trip to the Dome in 32 years that we've been playing the high school football playoffs. They won it all in 08, just their second trip here. One of the larger school districts in the state. Right now, Roosevelt is the largest. They got Washington and Central and Stevens and Lincoln. You know, they're all bunched up right there together.
Yeah, and for years, Rapid City Central was the biggest, correct?
Right, now it's Roosevelt. Well, on the season, perfect. They haven't done, they have a perfect record since 72. They haven't gone 10-0 since 1972. They did meet on September 13th, and in that game, Lincoln got off to a nice big start, but Roosevelt came back. They scored with 6 minutes to go in that ball game. It was 35-28. Lincoln kept the ball the rest of the game, never let Roosevelt get another opportunity to score.
There you see, they also defeated Watertown. Piled up the points early in the year. Then Brookings did a nice job on them defensively. Rapid City Stevens with the victory. They got the shutout win over Harrisburg and then defeated traditional rival Sioux Falls Washington in the finale of the regular season, 43-7. Opened up in the quarterfinals against Rapid City Stevens, 42-7. And then the shutout last week of Sioux Falls O'Gorman, 28-0.
And head coach Aaron Beavers talked with the folks from South Dakota Public Broadcasting earlier this week.
Last year when we ended the season, I knew we had an opportunity. I think this year after Inspirational Hills, you know, our breakaway, I knew we had something special. The key is that we get better each week, but once that Friday hits, we go to win the game. And, if you're thinking otherwise, why play it? And, so that's been our focus. They get better each week, and when it comes Friday, we want to win the game, and we've had some great game plans to accomplish that, and we've had some great play to accomplish that. They're a big play team, whether it's a big run or a big pass. And, they might rattle off one or two of those. We need to have an answer with that. And that doesn't mean a big play out of ours. That just means a sustained drive on the offense. But defensively, it's, we just got to slow them down. They're a special quarterback. They got some good receivers. The guys up front do a great job for them. We need to do a lot what we did the first time around, and that we just keep playing hard. We used the term, keep chopping wood. We got a great booster club here. The parents are great. The administration, the school, the fans, student body here is is awesome. We got some great, young men and women that are going to be entering society here soon, and I'm pretty proud of them also. It is another game. The only thing is, we all know it's our last game regardless. And we always talk about if you're going to the dance, you might as well dance. And we'll put our best two-step out there that we can.
That is Aaron Beavers. And by the way, he knows a little bit about the two-step. He was a coach down in Gregory for quite a while. And I know people along Highway 18 know how to two-step, Craig. There you get a look at the Lincoln Patriot student cheering section. Let's take a look at the starting lineups for these Lincoln Patriots.
Up front, it's been healthy all season, Mike, and it is a good offensive line. They are experienced with Van Veldhuizen, Peters, Roseboom, Sim, and Peters.
Kyle Sim, just a sophomore starting along that offensive line. His dad is an assistant coach for the University of Sioux Falls. Meanwhile, there will be a new starter at quarterback tonight, Craig, Isaiah Roach, but you've had a chance to see him a couple of times this year.
Yeah, he throws a real nice ball and can move around the pocket a lot quicker than Connor Burchill, but would not surprise me. Maybe we see Burchill somehow tonight. But Caden Quintanilla, top running back, one of the top running backs in the state, 1,600 yards. Where Lincoln goes, they follow Quintanilla. But they got a pretty good receiving core with Bartow, Nas, and Myers.
Indeed. And Matt Wagner, he will plow the way. But Quintanilla, one of those guys that is just absolutely electric to watch. He has been a four-year player as well.
Defensively.
Yeah, you won't see many players going both ways. That's one of the biggest differences you see in these big schools.
12 interceptions, 16 fumble recoveries, 23 sacks. And it starts up front with Rector. Reed West has been hurt, but he'll play tonight. Alex Anderson and Taylor Oshner. Linebackers, it's a good core with Large, Salava, and Matt Wagner. And then back deep, Fritz, Nas, Thanel, and Foss.
Yeah, so Wagner and Nas essentially the only, Wagner and Nas, the only two players going both ways, offensively and defensively. You'll notice that offensive line, Craig, they go with big players. But with the defensive line, both of these teams, they have chosen to go with speed. And so I think that's going to be very interesting to see that matchup tonight. And so it will be Lincoln taking on the Sioux Falls Roosevelt Rough Riders. You're watching High School Football Playoffs. By the way, just a reminder, Connor Burchill, the original starting quarterback, hurt his knee in their semifinal game last week. So that's why Isaiah Roach will be getting the start tonight. We'll be back to take a look at the Roosevelt Rough Riders after this timeout. You're watching High School Football on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. With Steve Toome and Craig Maddock, I'm Mike Henriksen at the Dakota Dome in Vermilion. 11 AAA football championships. Before we get into talking about the Roosevelt Rough Riders tonight, Craig, explain just why we are at the 11 AAA game.
Whoa, really? You want? Oh, that. Okay.
Well, no. Just explain that another class was added.
Another class was added, and it was determined that the top eight schools, the largest enrollments in South Dakota, would be comprised of 11 AAA. Now, Sioux Falls O'Gorman said, "Hey, we want to be a part of 11 AAA. We don't want to play in the current 11 AA format." So they were able to petition up and be a participant in 11 AAA. Which meant that Brandon Valley was the smallest of the top eight of enrollment. They could decide, well, we could move down to 11AA if somebody moves up. Well, O'Gorman moved up to AAA. Brandon Valley decided they want to stay 11AAA as well. So then the next smallest school was Watertown, and Watertown decided that they wanted to move down to 11AA. So the 11AAA, your top schools enrollment-wise for the most part, and then the next eight, largest eight, are made up of the 11AA
And that's
ranks.
One of the reasons we wanted to explain that is we know an awful lot of people only tune in during the state football championships. They maybe have a niece or a nephew who's involved in one of these schools or friends of theirs from work, And you may have been thinking, well, Saturday night is usually the 11AA championship. Well, you're correct, but this year we've got the 11AAA, which is the four Sioux Falls schools, Brandon Valley, Rapid City Stevens, Rapid City Central, and Aberdeen.
That's correct.
So
we've been doing
go.
This for 32 years, so it's something new this year. Triple A on a Saturday night.
Exactly.
There's got to be a song somewhere on that one.
Somebody will write it. Let's take a look at the Roosevelt Rough Riders as they come in. Of course, Sioux Falls Roosevelt, the newest high school in Sioux Falls, back in 1991, I believe.
Early 90s.
Yep, and they are on the west side of Sioux Falls. Cardinal red, gold, and white.
This is going to be their fifth appearance in the championship game. They won it all 2 years ago. They've got three titles to their name.
They came out with a shutout of Brandon Valley, a very impressive win to start the year down Washington. As Craig mentioned, they lost to Sioux Falls Lincoln. That's their only loss of the year. Then defeated Rapid City Central, Aberdeen Central, Mitchell, the shutout of Stevens, and the shutout or the victory over their traditional rival, Sioux Falls O'Gorman, 31-7 to wrap up the regular season. Then an 8-point win over Sioux Falls Washington. Washington, one of those teams that has been loaded with talent, but they graduated a lot of that talent. They continued to get better and gave Roosevelt a good run in that first round. And then what a wild one with Brandon Valley, Craig.
Statisticians are still in the hospital after that one. It was a wild one, and we'll certainly talk about the offensive weapons that Sioux Falls Roosevelt have. They have.
Let's hear from the head coach of the Roosevelt Rough Riders, Kim Nelson.
We started the year with high hopes, high expectations. We had some key players back from last year on both sides of the ball, and felt good about the young kids coming up, so we were really optimistic. And I think many other coaches knew that we had some pretty good players coming back. And so we were, I think, preseason number one for a couple of weeks anyway. Lincoln beat us in a pretty close game by a touchdown where we didn't think we played very well. We didn't think we were prepared very well. We didn't come out really hard, as hard as we should have. And Lincoln really took it to us. And so I'm hoping that memory is still in our heads from our previous game with them, and our players come out and know that we've got to get after it right away. I'm really happy that, first of all, that we're all healthy and that the guys that have made plays for us are still with us. And I think we're going to be tough to stop. I think we're going to have enough offense to really make it hard for Lincoln. We just have to try to be good enough on defense to get enough chances, I think. Our volleyball team just won their way into the state tournament last week, as just before we did. So it's a pretty good thing going in Roosevelt High School right now. I think our kids will really show up for the game. They always do, and I think it'll be a great crowd and a great atmosphere to play the toughest game of the year. I really hope that the game lives up to the hype. I think it will. I think it's going to be a very physical contest. I think we're going to, you know, get after each other pretty hard, and not just because we're rivalry teams, but we played each other earlier, and I think they know that we're good enough to win, and we know that they're good enough to win. So. It's going to be a battle.
Let's take a look at the starting lineups for the Roosevelt Rough Riders as you get a look at the student section.
This is an offensive line that also has been healthy and also very good.
Tevin, Kidd, Denovan, Hatfield, and Schmidt. Grant Schmidt, 6'7", 290-pound junior. He's getting offers to play college football from all across the country, big school programs. He's going to get nothing but better. Meanwhile, their offensive weapons, it all starts with Taryn Christian.
2,200-yard passer, almost 1,000-yard rusher. Bjordahl is the lone running back, but look at the weapons that Christian will throw to. Vinatieri, Benson, Mulba, and Hennings.
And yes, Vinatieri is related. He is the nephew of Adam Vinatieri. Meanwhile, defensively, again, take a look. They have decided to go with speed along that defensive line rather than huge size, as you've got Ironhawk, Newberg, Barsh, Lindquist, Hora, Janish at the linebackers, and also at linebacker, Nathan Durfee. And then Atwood, Wempner, Olinger, and Bren are the defensive backs. And so there you have a look at the Sioux Falls Roosevelt Rough Riders. We will be back to get you set to go Championship Night in 11 AAA on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. With Steve Toom and Craig Maddock, I'm Mike Henriksen. Craig Maddock, keys to the game tonight for the Roosevelt Rough Riders.
You got to watch Caden Quintanilla. He is a big-time player, one of the top rushers of all time, a top 10 rusher, 1,600 yards. But then when Roach is going to throw the ball, you got to watch out for Nas and Bartow. Matt Wagner could play a big part offensively for the Lincoln Patriots.
Yeah, Wagner is one of those kids that is just a terrific all-around player. He's going to have his opportunity to play on Saturdays also at fullback and at linebacker. Meanwhile, so Sioux Falls Lincoln, who do they have to be keeping an eye on when it comes to Roosevelt?
Number three, Taryn Christian, 2,200-yard passer, a 1,000-yard runner. You hold down Taryn Christian, you got a pretty good chance to win the game. Not many teams have been able to do that, though, this year.
The thing is, with Christian, too, it's similar to what we talked about with Cody Majors of Canton being such an outstanding point guard, and some of these quarterbacks being an outstanding point guard. Not only is he good, but he can also, he's got Mulbaugh back in the lineup. Yordahl can run the ball. Vinatarian, Benson, and Hennings can all catch the ball. This is a very, very fun team to watch. I think we're in for a dandy to wrap up our seven games of high school championships here at the Dakota Dome. Plus, this afternoon, of course, State and the U played, and South Dakota State picking up the road victory. With the kickoff coming your way shortly. As a matter of fact, right on the other side of this break, here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. All right, Steve, did you get us a prono?
Yes, I did. It's Quintanilla.
Okay.
And just something I noticed here, there's somebody from Sioux Falls Lincoln that has a vuvuzela down here.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes. I hope this does not catch on.
Okay, so you said Quintanilla.
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 Okay. Quintanilla.
Got All right, it. Sounds good.
Use the Quintanilla.
So a combination of the way we've got it. Okay. Yeah. So it's a combination of the Americanization and still the Spanish. It's a great crew behind the scenes working tonight to bring you the pictures and the sound from the Dakota Dome in Vermilion. And meanwhile, the voices you get to hear are Steve Toom, Craig Maddock, and myself, Mike Henriksen. Speaking of voices, we get the opportunity as we travel around to various events and state tournaments to hear some very, very good PA announcers. So we're always really blessed with that, including our buddy Kevin Phillips out in Rapid City, who seems like he's at everyone. But we are truly blessed when it comes to the state track meet and to being here in the Dakota Dome. There are very few PA announcers anywhere that are better than the gentleman that will bring you the intros tonight. We're ready to kick off Lincoln and Roosevelt. Let's hear from Greg Merrigan.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The South Dakota High School Activities Association welcomes you to the Dakota Dome in Vermilion for the State High School Class 11 AAA Football Championship Game. The Activities Association and its corporate partners, Sanford Health, First Premier Bank and Premier Bank Card, Farmers Union Insurance, Billion Automotive, and the South Dakota Army National Guard, remind you that interscholastic athletic and fine arts activities are an extension of the educational classroom, and that lessons are best learned when proper respect is given to everyone. Please let your good sportsmanship show during tonight's championship game. At this time, we direct your attention to the far sidelines. Let's meet the cheerleaders from both teams. First for Sioux Falls Lincoln, Shaylin Bird Sanvin, Sophie Brueckelman, Lauren Holm, Peyton Clywear, Matea Oppold, Savannah Phillips, Kelsey Sowers, Sophia Schwan, Zoe Simon, Brittany Scolland, Emma Heckel, and Julissa Reyna. And the cheerleaders for Sioux Falls Roosevelt, Kaylee Barse, Madison Jankowski, Anna Latza, Alexis Nelson, Austin Nelson, Darcy Roberts, Riley Selberg, Ashley Sestanich, Emma Smith, and Brielle Whalen. And now let's meet our starting lineups. First, the offensive unit for Sioux Falls Lincoln. Number 66, a center, Levi Roseboom. At right guard, number 75, Drew Peters. At left guard, number 77, Kyle Sim. At right tackle, number 71, Derek Peters. At left tackle, number 53, Mike Ben Veldhuizen. At tight end, number 46, Austin Drews. At split end, number 4, Dylan Bartow. At flanker, number 9, Trevor Naz. At quarterback, number 8, Isaiah Roach. At running back, number 25, Caden Quintanilla. And at fullback, number 36, Matt Wagner.
Let's go!
The Patriots are coached by Aaron Beavers, assisted by Brian Beckard, Jay Sim, Ken Doyle, Mario Massa, James Jervosky, Jeff Helseth, Chad Berger, Trey Erickson, Mike Magnuson, Sean Flanagan, Dave Elpers, Rico Hatter, and Drake Bachmeyer.
All right, yeah, however.
And now let's meet the defensive unit for Sioux Falls Roosevelt. Number 9, the nose guard, Skylar Newberg. At defensive tackle, number 44, Cody Barse. At defensive end, number 8, Corey Lindquist. At defensive end, number 54, Dante Ironhawk. At linebacker, number 10, Kirby Hora. At linebacker, number 32, Trevor Janish. At linebacker, number 21, Nathan Durfee. At strong safety, number 4, Kyle Olinger. At free safety, number 7, Ben Wepner. At cornerback, number 35, Austin Atwood. And at cornerback, number 29, Taylor Bren. The Riders are coached by Kim Nelson, assisted by Jared Fredenberg, Jason Whiting, Mike Leach, James Stubucker, Rob Cunningham, Jared Smith, Terry Jastrom, John Shadle, Joe Nelson, Micah Norden, Mike Greco, Chris Janish, and John Kolbuski. And now let's meet the officials for this championship game. The referee is Royce Wurzer from Rapid City. The umpire, John Whitcraft from Rapid City. The head linesman, Randy Stanton from Rapid City. The line judge, Greg Schumacher from Rapid City. The back judge, Brian Wilson of Rapid City. Williams, correction. And the alternate, Dana Nelson of Sioux Falls. And now, ladies and gentlemen, would you please rise, remove your hat, and place your hand over your heart. Veterans and military not in uniform may salute the flag as members of the Sioux Falls Lincoln Junior ROTC present the flag of our country. The members of the color unit are Cadet Captain Shana Williams, Cadet First Lieutenant Matthew Plucker, Cadet Staff Sergeant Brittany Helm, and Cadet Corporal Mason McManus, again from the Lincoln High School Marine Corps Junior ROTC. Our national anthem will be sung by the Bridgewater Emery Trio. Would you please remain standing until the colors have been retired?
Stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. O'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. And the rockets reclaim, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the
Thank you. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we direct your attention to the rafters in the Dakota Dome above the Sioux Falls Lincoln student crowd. Major Cadet Matt Davis of the South Dakota Army National Guard is rappelling down with our game ball. Thank you, Cadet Davis. And now members of the South Dakota Army National Guard will present tonight's game ball and a ceremonial coin for excellence for the championship game coin flip. The soldiers of the South Dakota National Guard salute tonight's players, coaches, and fans for exemplifying excellence in high school activities.
And so Roosevelt won the toss, but they have deferred, and Lincoln will get the ball first. Before we get into the football, one of the greatest additions that the Dome has seen this year is that rappelling of the ball down by the National Guard. And our special thanks to the National Guard. They provide the hospitality room and do a wonderful job here of being hosts and hostesses to all of us who are down here working at the Dakota Dome. We certainly appreciate all of the efforts year-round by the South Dakota National Guard. And what a terrific rendition of the national anthem. We've had some dandies this year, haven't we, Craig?
Yes, we have. We haven't had the trio before.
No.
Nicely done.
Yeah, that was excellent.
So Lincoln will get the ball first, and you're going to hear a lot about Caden Quintanilla. 20 100-yard games in his career. 9 times this year he's been over 100 yards. That's number 2 all-time in the 11-man football. That's the key for Roosevelt tonight.
Caden Quintanilla, got to make sure I say that right, and Adam Belhage will drop back deep to receive the kick from Chase Vinatieri. And again, in case you missed the pregame, yes, Chase is the nephew of Adam Vinatieri.
He's only had 7 touchbacks this year, so most of the kickoffs have been returnable by Vinatieri.
And so we are set to go. 11 AAA history underway. Belage will take it in the end zone. A reminder that in high school, if the ball goes into the end zone, you are not allowed to run it out. And so consequently, the Lincoln offense will start on their own 20-yard line. Craig, we are not seeing the veteran in there for Sioux Falls Lincoln tonight, Connor Burchill, the 6'1 senior who injured himself last week in the playoffs with a knee. What is the key for Isaiah Roach, who is getting his first start tonight at quarterback?
He can throw the ball. It has a real nice spiral in it. I think just getting custom into the game. He's thrown 2 touchdowns this year. He has not thrown a pick, though, this year.
They come into the spread formation. Quintanilla goes in motion, gets the handoff, and falls forward for just a couple of yards. Again, along the defensive line for both of these teams is speed and quickness rather than size, while both offensive lines have the size advantage.
You know, with Isaiah Roach, it's not like this is his first start and he's never worked with the first team. He has been in a number of games this year. He's worked with the first team. Won't take him long to get accustomed to being in this game.
But at the same time, this is the Dome. Quintanilla muscles his way out past the 25 to near the 26. It will bring up a 3rd down for the Lincoln Patriots.
This Roosevelt defense, they go the 4-3. That front four for Roosevelt with Lindquist, Barce, Newberg, and Ironhawk, they've got 4 interceptions on that front four. They're able to move around, get tip passes, get the hands up if there's a ball thrown near their way.
Once again, Roach goes out of the empty backfield. The throw, pick off, he's gone. The pick 6. That is his 3rd interception of the season, and the Roosevelt Rough Riders are on the board.
He just stood back and watched it. Good timing on the throw by Roach. First pick of the year by Isaiah Roach.
And it came at a very inopportune time, obviously. So Roosevelt on the board. Kick is up, and the kick from Vinatieri is good out of the hold of Taryn Christian. So Taryn Christian has been on the field, but just a hold for the extra point, and yet Roosevelt is on the board here in the early going. We are very excited here at South Dakota Public Broadcasting coming up tonight following the football game. No cover, no minimum, featuring the incredible Sheryl Crow. She was at Jazz Fest and so was South Dakota Public Broadcasting. And for those of you that were there, you'll want to see it again. For those of you that weren't, the reports are she just tore it up. So that comes your way tonight. No cover, no minimum. Sheryl Crow, approximately 10 o'clock tonight, following football.
That Roosevelt defense, those 11 starters, they've had 11 interceptions this year, so that would be the 12th of the year of those starters. You mentioned three times Atwood has picked one off. First one, though, he's been able to take to the house.
And so now Lincoln in the early hole. They'll get their offense right back out there. Third play of the game. Again, that's where one of the differences between Roach. Yes, he has played, but he has not started. And the pressure of being in the Dakota Dome, the experience you get,
you
playing
don't
so many
get,
varsity games.
But you don't want to get timid now.
Right. Very true.
If you get timid, you're in trouble. You got to keep in there, be positive.
Keep doing the things you do.
Right.
And so Vinatieri will let it fly. And once again, Quintanilla and Bellage are back. There's the kick. That is going to be fielded by Quintanilla at the two. Shifted to the outside. He's tripped up. Nice play defensively. I believe that was, want to give credit, Jake Bear, the junior running back. Jake Bear is able to come up with a big play, but a penalty flag on the play.
And that was away from the tackle. Oh, personal foul against the Patriots. That flag came away from where Quintanilla was tackled.
Yeah, that was about 10 yards away from the play.
Dead ball, personal foul against the receiving team. Half the distance to the goal, first down.
Well, things have not started out. Couldn't have started out much worse for Sioux Falls Lincoln here. They throw the pick six, and now on a poor return to begin with, the penalty means they will be starting at their own 7-yard line.
Going to go four wide, too, Mike.
Empty backfield once again. Man comes in motion and gets the handoff. That is Quintanilla, and he will get out past the 10 to the 12-yard line. A good pickup on first down for Caden. Again, Caden, one of those kids that has seen time since he was a freshman. And that happens in the biggest classes very, very rarely.
2 years in a row, he has rushed for over 1,000 yards. This year, 1,600 yards, 25 touchdowns. The all-time season TD record is 29 by fellow Lincoln grad Gannon Moore. Last time Lincoln was in the Dome in 08.
The handoff goes to Quintanilla, and he will be tackled for a loss this time as that defensive right side of the line came in. Bars and Lindquist. Skyler Newberg was in on it as well, and so it brings up third down and long.
Last time these two teams met, that was back in September. Lincoln got out to a quick lead. They got up by, I believe, it was three scores. And in the second half, Roosevelt chipped away at it, got within one score. But with 6 minutes to go in the game, Lincoln had it and never gave up the ball.
Roach drops back, rolls right, throws short, incomplete. And so the Roosevelt defense off to a terrific start tonight. The pick six and now the three and out. And it will be Lincoln forced to punt, and Roosevelt should get the ball in good field position. When they catch this punt, dropping back deep will be Austin Atwood, the man who has the touchdown so far on the night. That ball was thrown low and left, and Quintanilla would have had no chance to do anything with it anyway. Trevor Nas will let it fly from his own goal line. Off the side of his foot and out of bounds. Oh. And Roosevelt is going to have terrific field position to start.
Nas averages 35 yards a punt, but that one was about a 15-yarder.
It goes out of bounds at the 25-yard line, and that's where Roosevelt will take over first down and 10. Taryn Christian, they will go no huddle all night. They can use this as a hurry up. but they can also just use it to keep the defense from switching up players. The throw, interference. It was intended for Chase Vinatieri, and he got bumped by Levi Foss.
And that's not like the NFL, Mike, where they get the ball at the one-yard line. This will be from the line of scrimmage. Typically a 15-yard penalty. Trying to go down the seam.
Defensive pass interference. Half the distance to the goal. First down.
Since the ball was at the 25, move it half the distance to the goal where it will be first down and 10 yards to go. So the ball will be at the 12 and a half.
Yeah, Riders won't ever huddle. They got wristbands with all their plays. Sometimes they'll get set here and then look to the sideline to see what play they're on.
Sam Denovan is the center. Christian, lone setback, keeps it himself, and he is mauled. Wagner, Salava, Ochsner, they were all there.
Not only does Roosevelt have a great trio of linebackers, Lincoln's three linebackers, we're going to say their names a lot tonight. It is a great front seven for Lincoln.
So a loss of a couple on the play, second and 12. Again, Christian has Bjordahl as his setback. Vinatieri goes in motion. Rolling right side. Tucking it, running it, reversing it. He thought he had a lane, but that lane closed up quickly. Again, the speed of those linebackers and defensive linemen. Still a pickup of about five for Taryn Christian.
With this,
but now third down.
With this spread offense, Mike, we're going to be seeing a lot of one-on-one coverage of the DBs and the wide outs. And that time, good coverage by Lincoln. Christian just had to run it. And Lincoln did a good job with their linebackers right there with Salava and Wagner to stay at home.
Christian throws, almost intercepted. It went right over the hands of Braxton Large and was behind the intended receiver, David Mulbaugh. And so that will bring up fourth down. And Chase Vinatieri will be on to try to convert a field goal.
He is 5 of 6 on the season. His long has been 37.
This one will be from 27 yards.
He's 1 for 2 from this range on the season.
The holder is Taryn Christian, so keep your eye on him. Yep, they'll kick it. The kick is up. The kick is good. And so the Roosevelt Rough Riders, with their first offensive possession, come up with 3. And they've got the early lead, 10-0. Craig, you got to think, though, if you're on that Lincoln sideline, the way things have started for them, only giving up 3 there, that's a victory.
Totally agree. You know, they haven't had the best field position at all in their 2 possessions. It has limited them a little bit offensively where they have started. They needed to get out past the 20 for them to really possibly get Roach to feel more comfortable back there.
Our thanks to the website, sdsportshistory.com. You can become a subscriber to sdsportshistory.com. It is a great compilation of records in various sports through the years. It's brought to you by Shoneman's, and our thanks to Dan Gensler and Dave Kemp, who are keeping us posted on what's going on record-wise.
By the way, in each of the last 2 games, Roosevelt has had a defensive special teams touchdown in the first offensive series. They had a punt block that went for a TD against Brandon Valley. And now tonight, the pick 6.
And so Vinatieri, who you are getting very familiar with here in the first 4 minutes of this game. His kick is away. And that will be grabbed by Belhaj. And he's going to be swarmed under. He may want to rethink that decision when he looks at the tape. He went up in the air to grab it to keep it from going into the end zone, wanting to make a play. And that's easy to understand, Craig. When you've seen things go poorly, everybody wants to make a play and get this turned around.
Yeah, I should let it go into the end zone. They'll start again from inside their own 20.
And so coming out of the huddle, Isaiah Roach in his first start tonight due to the injury to senior quarterback Connor Burchill. Roach, the junior, goes under center. Power I formation. They'll give it to Caden Quintanilla. And he will be swarmed under. Nice job defensively by Kirby Hora. And Craig, you've watched Kirby play for quite a few years, too.
Yeah.
Kid's fun.
Again, that linebacking core with Hora, Janish, and Durfee. The front seven for Roosevelt, again, just as strong as Lincoln. They're not maybe the biggest, but they're certainly quick.
These two teams have been ranked number one and number two in the KWSN poll all season long. There is no question that these two are the best two football teams in the state of South Dakota. Roach looks to pass, now tucks it, and he is going to be taken down for a loss. As this offense is heading the wrong direction for the Lincoln Patriots.
Mike, he had no one to throw to. You got to give that coverage defense for Roosevelt. They were covering Nas and Bartow and Myers. Roach didn't have anybody to throw to.
And so it will be third down now and 15 yards to go.
Isaiah Roach has also been, in fact, he can be a receiver at times.
Yeah, they've worked to get him into the lineup. This was not the way they would have preferred to do that. The throw, the catch, but not enough for the first down, I don't believe. He will come up short. The pass was to Trevor Nas. And for those of you familiar with South Dakota sports history, yes, he is the grandson of Harvey Nas, the longtime coach out at Winter. He does come up just shy of the first down.
Yeah, I think you got a punt here.
It's going to be fourth down and a long yard and a half.
They're going for it, Mike.
They may come up. They're going to go in the I formation. They may just be trying to draw Roosevelt off sides here, see if they can get a free one. They can't, so they'll take the timeout. Roosevelt on top of Lincoln, 10-0. There you get a good look at Aaron Beavers. Having a talk with Isaiah Roach.
Coach Beavers, 10th year at Lincoln.
Has it been that long?
Yeah. He's had success when he was at Gregory. Well, Kim Nelson, fifth year for the Riders. That's not Kim.
That's
right
not
there.
Kim, yeah. And so it will be fourth down, and Lincoln will spend the timeout. And on to do the punting will be Nas. Trevor Nas, 6'1", 180, and a senior. Big brother, there's a good look at Kim Nelson. Big brother plays at University of Sioux Falls.
Nas needs to get a good kick here.
Atwood is back to receive it. That's a better, much better punt. Atwood takes the fair catch and will step aside. Roosevelt on top of Lincoln, 10-0. We're back to the Dakota Dome and Vermilion after this timeout on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. With Steve Toom and Craig Maddock, I'm Mike Henriksen. At the Dakota Dome in Vermilion, Sioux Falls Roosevelt with a lead here in the early going.
17 total yards for Lincoln, 2 for Roosevelt.
And 16 of those came on one pass. So the first time that Lincoln has played defense, the first time Roosevelt has touched the ball. Or excuse me, handoff, I take that back. Handoff goes to Bjordahl, second time, of course, as they were able to get a field goal out of their last possession.
Yeah, you lead by 10, and you have 2 total yards of offense.
Seth Bjordahl with that carry picks up a couple yards.
Best game of the year was against Mitchell, over 200 yards.
Jaron Christian Good snap from Denovan. He'll look left side. He's got a man in the seam. Vinatieri makes the cut. Foot race to the end zone. Goes on the angle. Drug down at the 12-yard line as Levi Foss comes up with the tackle.
Vinatieri, the leading receiver, and he is hurt on the play. He's also, remember, the kicker. And he injured on the play. It looks like it's shoulder. Pointed to the shoulder. Came down hard on that turf on the tackle. But Vinatieri came into the game with 38 receptions, which was number one on the team. Nice move as he gets tackled here by Levi Foss. He does get up. Yeah. And walking off now onto the sideline.
I think you're exactly right, Craig. I think he fell on that shoulder. He ran, he found the seam in the zone, and Christian with the strike. So first down, 10 yards to go. And now a penalty flag down.
Normally that goes on the offense.
False start on the offense.
What we're seeing in this contest, Mike, when again, Roosevelt, when they're spreading this
dead
out.
Ball, false start against the offense, 5-yard penalty, first down.
We're seeing one-on-one coverage defensively. So the DBs, one-on-one coverage with the wide receivers for Roosevelt. It'll be nice to see some of these matchups.
Christian has Bjordahl as his lone setback. Throw, left side, has a man. Pick up of 5 yards, but that'll do it. As coming up with that catch is the man who is in Jake Bear. Jake came in replacing Chase Vinatieri.
He had 18 catches coming into this game. Because you got Hennings and Vinatieri and Benson and Mulba and Wempner and Bear. I mean, they have a lot of weapons on this Ryder receiving corps.
So it will be second down now, 10 yards to go. Roosevelt looking to add to their lead. Christian. Hammered. Matt Wagner.
He had 2 sacks coming into the championship game, and he shot the gap. Nobody touched him. Christian has only thrown the ball 3 times. He's 2 for 3 for 46 yards.
And so it will be third down now. 20 yards to go. Again, they use the no huddle, not necessarily as a speed-up technique. The fake handoff. Christian under pressure. He escapes. No, he doesn't. Running him down from behind is Dylan Arntz. Just what the doctor and the defensive coordinator of Lincoln needed.
Salava missed him first, and then Reed West missed him. Finishing off Dylan Arntz. And now, since Vinatieri is hurt, they bring in their backup kicker, Isaiah Bauer.
Isaiah is 5'9", 165, and a sophomore. This will be a 47-yard attempt. The kick. Nope. And so Lincoln is able to come up with a huge defensive stand. Roosevelt misses an opportunity.
That was Bauer's first attempt this year. He's kicked off once. Well, that was his first field goal try of the year.
But again, with Vinatieri going down, the sophomore is called upon. And so it will be first down and 10 yards to go.
Let's see if that Lincoln defense will spark this Lincoln offense.
I formation. Quintanilla dots the I. Wagner the fullback. Quintanilla gets into some space. Jumps away. Steps away. Foot race. Will he angle away? He will. 80 yards. Caden Quintanilla. With that run, Quintanilla has just passed Jordan Johnson, a spearfish. He's now number 9 all-time rusher in 11-man football. And what a run it was. That was vintage Quintanilla.
Schuster, 52 of 55 on the season. We got ourselves a football game.
Terrence Schuster puts it in. Boy, oh boy. In the first 3 minutes, Craig, the Sioux Falls Lincoln coaching staff and fans specifically, not the staff necessarily, but the fans, they had to feel like the roof of this dome was falling in on them. But that defensive stand was huge. And now to get the 80-yard run, suddenly things are going Lincoln's way.
I remember when Quintanilla was a freshman, he was, what, 5'6", 135 pounds?
Yep.
Soaking wet.
But, boy, he could fly back then, too, couldn't he?
And he has worked really hard over the last couple of years. Again, he's a three-year starter. 1,600 yards this year just shows how explosive he can be, and that has got to be the number one look of any Roosevelt defense, looking where number 25 is.
Yeah, Caden hasn't grown taller by much. He's now 5'8", but he has certainly developed. He is 175, and again, with that incredible burst.
Over 3,500 career yards for Quintanilla.
And so Terrence Schuster will kick it off. First time that the Roosevelt Rough Riders will be receiving a kick tonight. Atwood is deep. It's a short kick, and very wisely. That's a smart kid right there.
Justin Hatfield.
Yeah, Justin, the 5'9", 200-pound senior. It's an offensive lineman's dream to get your hands on the ball, but he also knew how that dream could turn into a nightmare if he tried to run. So he grabs it and falls.
He's the starting guard for those Riders.
So he ends up.
Taryn Christian has not been able to run the ball at all. Lincoln's defense has done a pretty good job.
A bad snap, fumble. I think that Lincoln has it. I believe that that's number 71, Derek Peters. Alex Anderson, excuse me. Yep, Anderson right there, the 5'10", 295-pound senior. Craig, it would it be easy to say that football is a game of momentum?
It has in the last 3 minutes in this one.
Got to turn my sheet back over here. Roach with Wagner at the fullback. Quintanilla dots the eye. Nas in motion. Roach drops back. Throws, has a man, caught, no! Touchdown! Dylan Bartow with the catch.
Roach threw this up like a can of corn. And Bartow, like a center fielder, trying to get under it. Over Atwood. And it looked like he got both feet in. At least from our angle, right in the corner of the end zone.
The kick is good.
14 straight points for the Patriots.
Boy, oh boy, you talk about Saturday night heavyweight fights. That's kind of what we're seeing so far, huh? Roosevelt gets the pick six to go on top on the third play of the game. And then a poor punt by Lincoln gives Roosevelt wonderful field position, and Vinatieri drills a field goal. Poor field position hampers Lincoln once again, but Roosevelt unable to do anything about it because of the great defensive stand by Lincoln. Then Lincoln with the 80-yard run by Caden Quintanilla. A fumble recovery on the first play from scrimmage after the kickoff, and the touchdown from Roach to Bartow.
Two plays, two touchdowns.
The kick, again, a low line drive kick. They're going to kick it away from the deep men. Returned that time by number 32. That will be Trevor Janish. The senior gets it back up to the 30-yard line.
Last time Roosevelt had the ball, mentioned that Taryn Christian has been held offensively by this Lincoln defense. Officially, Christian four carries for minus 16 yards. Two for three passing for 46.
He has been under pressure when he has dropped back to pass. Christian, this time the pocket holds. Has a man, Mobaugh, caught, and he is drugged down at the 27-yard line. David Mobaugh comes up with the catch.
Don't think we're going to see a lot of 3 yards in a cloud of dust tonight. Keyshawn Britt was on Mobaugh. Mobaugh able to get by him. Big play.
Ball's first and 10 at the 28-yard line. Handoff. Yordal sweeping the left side. Can't get outside as Nas comes up with the tackle. Craig, I am darn glad I got a good nap this afternoon. As a matter of fact, I got a couple of them, so I'm raring to go this evening, and we're going to need our energy. This could go a while.
24 points in the first quarter.
Wow. And both teams just so explosive.
Of course, the last game Roosevelt was in, they scored 100 points between the two.
This time, Christian takes it himself up the middle. He'll get past one man and drug down from behind. Levi Foss comes up with the tackle just outside the 10-yard line, but a fresh set of downs for the Roosevelt Rough Riders.
Roosevelt averages 230 yards passing a game, just under 200 yards rushing per game. Fairly even the number of plays passing and rushing.
So Christian, they can still get a first down. They'll hand it to the man coming around the side and not getting anywhere is Jake Bear. Jake, who is in for Chase Vinatieri, who got hurt on a catch earlier in the game, a loss of a couple of yards. Craig, both of these teams with as much speed as they have defensively, it's tough to get outside of the tackles, isn't it?
Almost, you have the most success with the quick hitters going right up the middle. These linebackers, again, for both teams, they're quick. And again, the linemen aren't that big, they're quick.
Christian bobbles it. Falls on it, loss on the play. All the way back to the 22-yard line.
One thing you'll see different with the Roosevelt offense, and really no other school does this, is their gaps offensively with their center and the guards and the tackles. Their gaps are almost twice as big, twice as wide as you'll see with other schools.
That wasn't on Sam Denovan, the center. That was just bobbled by Christian, and we come to the end of the first quarter. Chance to catch our breath. Lincoln 14, Roosevelt 10. Back to the Dakota Dome on South Dakota Public Broadcasting right after this timeout. With Steve Toome from South Dakota Public Broadcasting, Craig Maddock from Sioux Falls Sports Radio, KWSN. I'm Mike Henriksen from SportsMax Radio and calling all sports. Third down for the Roosevelt Rough Riders. They led it 10 to nothing in the very early going. Lincoln with two successive touchdowns has taken the lead. There you see, Craig, just what you were talking about, those gaps with the offensive line. Christian rolls out, right side, throws, end zone.
Flag.
That will be 15 yards and an automatic first down. Mulba and Foss, got tangled up. And the penalty flag will go on Levi Foss.
Yeah, that's going to be half the distance to the goal, and I would assume that should be an automatic first down, even though
it is.
It would have been, third and goal to the one, or third down in 22?
Defensive pass interference, half the distance to the goal, third down.
It is third down. Sorry about that. Not automatic. My bad.
Okay.
Again, the rules change from Saturday afternoon to Friday nights to Sunday afternoon, so I get confused on them every now and then myself. I do know that in high school football, if you are getting beat by the wide receiver, tackle him. The throw, Christian to Mulba, caught! In the exact same corner, the exact same play as the last pass from Lincoln.
They like that corner of the end zone. Mulba, his seventh touchdown catch of the year.
David is 6'3 and 185. He went up over Keyshawn Britt, pulled it down, and Roosevelt will take the lead back. The kick. Matt Wagner was the man who went tumbling. But the kick is good.
That was Isaiah Bauer again. He's in for Vinatieri. Bauer with his first extra point of the year.
All sorts of great programming coming your way on South Dakota Public Broadcasting for the holidays, including two of my favorite musicians on the planet, and I don't care what level that is. The Hegg Brothers are on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. John and Jeremy are just incredibly talented. I've been delighted that I have gotten to be friends with them through the years, but their talent still just awes me. And the place to find local quality talent is usually only on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Total yards, Lincoln 120, Roosevelt 83. Roosevelt is minus 16 rushing, 99 yards passing. Lincoln, 84 yards rushing, 36 yards passing. Of course, Quintanilla got 80 of those 84 in that one touchdown.
Exactly. Every now and then there are misleading stats.
Quintanilla, by the way, one of nine players all time with 3,500 rushing yards. Of course, Jason Lieber, the all-time rushing leader in South Dakota with 5,300.
That's nuts.
I don't know if that one will ever be touched. Jason Lieber of Vermilion.
Yep, he set that record. Most of those yards came right here in this building. Delage will get wrapped up. Mulba is in on the defensive tackle. He catches the touchdown and then he makes the tackle.
I have a feeling we're going to see a lot of yards in this one.
I think so.
Big plays, both these teams with the athletes to make the big plays.
So Isaiah Roach will bring out Sioux Falls Lincoln.
Now Roach is 2 for 4 passing for 36 yards and one score.
Caden Quintanilla, now Wagner is the fullback. I formation, Quintanilla at the line. This time they'll wrap him up. Leading the way was Trevor Janish, the 6 foot, 205 pound senior. A pickup of just a couple, if we're being gracious. Mark it out to the 25 yard line. Second down and 8 yards to go.
Roach, after the play, has to run to the sideline, gets the play from head coach Aaron Beavers, and then runs back to the huddle.
Again, the I formation. They started out in the spread offense, and that was not going well. Once they went I formation, things have gone better. Handoff, Balazs on the end around. He's got the first down, makes a man miss. Down the sideline, he'll be dropped down inside Roosevelt territory.
40-yard run and an injured Roosevelt Rough Rider. Boy, he got out to the outside and found that seam. And
he made Janish miss there. And then he's drugged down from behind by Taylor Bren. But let's see who the injured player is back at the 25-yard line for the Roosevelt Rough Riders.
Bill Hodge came into the game with only 60 yards rushing on the season.
And that is Kyle Olinger, the 6 foot, 180-pound senior.
Yeah, he came in from his safety spot, tried to make the tackle.
Good to see him walking off without any assistance. Hopefully we see him again. Again, Roosevelt has already lost out on Vinatieri. So first down, 10 yards to go. The ball at the 39-yard line of the Roosevelt Rough Riders. Is this going to be one of those games that the last team that has the ball wins the game, Craig?
Good. Yep. I believe it.
High formation. Bell Hodge in motion. Handoff, Quintanilla. Quintanilla powers his way past the 35 to the 33-yard line.
Lincoln has the opportunity to sustain some long drives. I mean, that's what they did with Roosevelt in when they played earlier this year. It was a one-score game. Roosevelt had just scored. They had all the momentum. 6 minutes to go in the game. But Roosevelt started at their 20, and they just kept driving, getting just first down after first down, and they ran the clock out, and Roosevelt never touched the ball again. So the Patriots have an opportunity to do that.
Here comes Lincoln again, going back to that spread formation. Roach will keep it himself up the middle, and he will have enough for the first down, down to the 27-yard line.
I've always been a fan of the spread offense. I just believe that with the spread offense, you spread out that defense, and then it allows your top players to make a play, find a seam or a little hole to get the job done.
And it was Kim Nelson, who is now the head coach at Roosevelt, who essentially brought the spread to the big schools in South Dakota when he was the head coach at Sioux Falls, Washington. Lone setback is Wagner. Wagner stays on his feet, gets to the outside. 10, 5, touchdown! But a penalty flag is down.
He had better moves than Gene Kelly. Well, for all you youngins out
there. Yeah, that's right. Use your Google machine.
But what a spin move, but that's coming back.
Holding, and that was right at the point of attack, too.
Holding against the offense, 10-yard penalty, first down.
So move it back to the 30-yard line. It takes off a terrific run by Matt Wagner.
Typically, he's blocking for Caden Quintanilla. It shows Matt Wagner's got some speed.
He does.
He gets to the outside.
So first down and 12 yards to go. Remember, the penalty is marked off from the spot of the foul, not from the line of scrimmage. Roach drops back, open, man out on the right side, that's Jones.
Dalton Jones. He came in for Matt Wagner on that play, and now Jones is going to go out. Matt Wagner comes in. He just went a down and out, wide open. And the junior gets positive yardage.
So back to the line of scrimmage. First down and 10 now. Hand off. Quintanilla goes nowhere. Nice job defensively by Corey Lindquist. 6'3", 220, and a senior. He is the biggest man on that defensive line, and he wears number 8. Clock rolling here near the 9-minute mark. Plenty of action so far from the Dakota Dome in Vermilion. Here come the Lincoln Patriots. Roosevelt led. Lincoln took the lead. On the wideout is Quintanilla with the empty backfield. Roach, though, looks the other way. He will have no time, and down he goes.
Dante Ironhawk was the first rider to get there.
And then Cody Bars finished him off.
Ironhawk, one of those defensive ends for Roosevelt. Lindquist and Ironhawk, some pretty good bookends for that defensive line. Bars and Newberg are the defensive tackles.
And so third down and long.
We'll give Ironhawk the sack. That would be his second sack of the year.
Isaiah Roach will go with the empty backfield. Three split wide on his left, two split wide on his right. The snap, he's under pressure, gets it off. Gets it to Nas, but Nas is going to lose yardage.
Trevor Janish staying at home as a linebacker. Yeah, a lot of pressure by Lindquist.
A big defensive stand for the Roosevelt Rough Riders, as it looked like Lincoln was on the march. As a matter of fact, they had a touchdown taken away by a holding penalty. And so now it's field goal time.
Taren Schuster, 4 for 4 on the season. His long has been 35.
This one is from 41 yards out. The kick. Good!
He was practicing before the game tonight. He practiced from 42, didn't go any further. That one from 41.
Tying the game at 17 is Schuster on the 41-yard field goal. Once again, if the ball is marked at the 31, there is the extra 10 yards to get it through the uprights in the end zone. What an entertaining football game this has been so far.
Boy, Mike, if it does come down to the kicking game at the end, boy, that would really put a dent with Roosevelt, because their kicker is Chase Vinatieri, who certainly has a great leg,
but has been out of the game.
Shoulder, apparent shoulder injury. So they have Bauer doing the kicking now.
Dropping back to receive. Jake Bear is back there with Atwood. Here's a look at Jake Bear.
Schuster's only had 10 touchbacks this year. Most of his kicks have been returnable.
They'll keep it low and on the ground. It's fallen on at the 29-yard line. They have no interest in kicking it to Atwood, who scored earlier on an interception return, or Bear. They're just going to keep taking their chances with the low kicks and no returns. So in a tie game, there's a look at Aaron Beavers. Taren Christian brings his troops out. The junior quarterback in his second year of starting. Drops back, fires. Just a little miscommunication, I think, with Tanner Hennings.
Yeah, threw that well behind him. Christian now 4 of 6 passing for 99 yards. Again, Christian almost 1,000-yard rusher as well, but tonight 6 carries for -8.
He has been sacked several times. Again, take a look at the gaps between the center, the guard, the tackle. Christian steps up, fires well over Mulbaugh, and there's some more communication. David Mulbaugh had cut off his route, was coming across the middle. Christian thought he was going to continue towards the end zone.
Yep, threw it 10 yards past Mulba.
And so it will bring up third down and 10. The ball at the 30-yard line. Ebbs and flows in this one. Man. Christian fires over the head of Tanner Hennings, and that will bring up fourth down.
Taylor Salava, the middle linebacker for Lincoln, coming in on the blitz. Gave a nice hit on Christian as he released the ball.
Take a look pressure. At the arm strength there of Taren Christian as he was rolling to his left, throwing across his body, and certainly had plenty of zip on that.
Well, he's also the punter. He averages 27 yards a punt.
And a timeout going to be called. Yep. 1, 2, 3, 4, time 5, out. 6, 7, Lincoln. 8, That's 9, 10, second. 11. They had 12 players on the field. That's why the special teams coach called the timeout, because they had 12 players on the field.
Lincoln returned 8 offensive starters. They brought back 8 defensive starters from last year. Roosevelt brought back 8 offensive starters, 6 defensive starters. When you have that high number of players coming back, typically you'll see success the following year.
And especially, it wasn't like these two teams were bad last year. They were very, very successful last year as well.
Roosevelt lost in the semifinals last year. Lincoln lost in the quarterfinals.
So fourth down, and now Lincoln has the right number of players out on the field. And dropping back is Caden Quintanilla. Christian will let it fly from about his own 20.
Let's see if he punts to him now.
Oh, nice punt. Quintanilla goes back to his own 25. And he will be cut down, and there's a penalty flag. What a play defensively.
That was a 50-yard punt.
Coming up on the coverage was Austin Atwood. Look at this. It's a rocket punt. Quintanilla will be driven back to catch that. There's a clip right there, and Atwood still makes the tackle.
Just shows you the athleticism on all these kids out there tonight.
Let's get the explanation.
Could be half the distance to the goal.
Block in the back against the receiving team. 10-yard penalty. First.
So there you go. Mark the ball at the 12-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Roach, empty backfield. Hands off to Belage. Belage, past the 20. Nice pickup by Adam Belhaj. Second down for the Lincoln Patriots.
His last carry went for 36. This one went for 9. So he's got 2 carries and 45 yards tonight.
You just keep getting this feeling, Craig, every time the ball is snapped, something big is going to happen.
It's because both of these teams have a lot of athletes that can.
Quintanilla is now the lone setback. He'll run it out of the, they used to call it the Wildcat formation. I'm not sure what they call it on the Lincoln sideline, but the direct snap went to Quintanilla, and he will run forward for the first down. Nickel Myers will check into the lineup now for Lincoln.
Roach coming back in with the play.
So first down, the ball at the 25-yard line. Lincoln and Roosevelt. Tied at 17 apiece here in the second quarter. Roach gets good.
Oh
man, that was fortunate. He was going to Quintanilla, but Kirby Hora was certainly not fooled. And Roach is fortunate that that pass was wide right, because that had 6 the other way written all over it.
Well, he looked to his right, then knew he was going to pass left. And
Hora was there. It was between Hora and Trevor Janish is where the ball sailed. So second down and 10.
Roach is 4 for 6 passing, 46 yards, and 1 pick.
The pick went for 6. There's a throw down the seam, caught by Nas. First down into Roosevelt territory at the 41-yard line.
Nice throw by the junior. Nas was right there in the seam. Nobody within 5 yards of Nas. Great job throwing this thing up, and Nas.
adjust to it. It looks like almost if he would have continued to move, he would have caught that in stride, but instead he jumps. Trevor Nas, the 6'1 senior, his brother Trey, is the all-time leader in receptions in high school football in South Dakota. Trey had 199 in his career, now playing at the University of Sioux Falls. And again, thanks to the folks at sdsportshistory.com for that information. So second down, 7 yards to go. SDSportsHistory.com, sponsored by Schoenemann's. Roach will bring the play in. Roach, empty backfield again. Now Wagner will line up on his right side. Three wides to the right. The throw, overthrown, intended for Nas, incomplete.
Caden Quintanilla now has 11 carries, 102 yards. He now has 21 career 100-yard rushing games. Jason Lieber of Vermilion with the all-time mark with 25 100-yard games.
So it will be third down here and 7 yards to go. Clock stops on the incomplete pass. Steve Toon and Craig Maddock, I'm Mike Henriksen. Big third down opportunity for Roosevelt to come up defensively here. Handoff, nope, the fake. Roach rolls right, has room to run. Gets to the 30, first down and out of bounds. He will get to the 25-yard line. First down for Lincoln Patriots.
Sorry, Mike, Matt Wagner springing the block. Watch for number 36. Here he comes. He will lead the way and give Roach enough room to get the first down.
Good job by the Roosevelt players also of backing off there, realizing where they were on the field and not coming up with that little extra hit or shove. Swinging wide to the left side is Dylan Bartow. He's got a catch for a touchdown already. Full house backfield, handoff, Quintanilla goes nowhere.
Trevor Janish, linebacker, shot the gap. Perfect timing.
Loss of half a yard. Clock continuing to roll here at 4.5 minutes to play in the first half. Both teams settling in here on this drive.
Lincoln with 245 yards of offense. Roosevelt under 100 yards of offense. But we're tied.
Turnovers have been the keys for Roosevelt so far. There's a throw to Bartow in the corner, and he can't make the adjustment, and no flag.
Taylor Brand on the coverage on Bartow, one-on-one. Ball was underthrown. Allowed Brand to get in the way of the pass.
So Roach gets the play from the sideline. In he comes on third down. A few fresh bodies into the lineup for Lincoln. Mike Van Veldhuizen comes back into the lineup. He had been on the sideline. He's a big man at left tackle. Roach blitz. Van Veldhuizen just got a piece of that blitzer, but a penalty flag is down. Roach tried to make some chicken salad out of chicken feathers there, but the penalty flag is going to negate it. A hold on Sioux Falls Lincoln.
I think you want to take the penalty. You want to move him back. Otherwise,
holding.
This would be fourth
it's
down.
It's the offense. Penalties declined. Fourth down.
Well, this leaves them actually in field goal position.
That's right. That's what I was saying. I think maybe you'd want to take the penalty to move him back so you wouldn't allow the field goal because Schuster can hit it from here.
He just hit a 41-yarder. Or 42-yarder. This will be a 41-yarder.
Again, he was only practicing from 42 yards out. That's the furthest he was practicing tonight. So he has hit it from here before.
The spot by Roach. The kick is up. Is it going to hang in left? It does. And so they turn down the penalty, give him fourth down, and Lincoln nails the field goal. Lincoln on top of Roosevelt, 20-17. We're back after this timeout on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. A pair of 41-yard field goals off of the foot of Taryn Schuster. And now Lincoln is back on top, 20-17.
Schuster came into the game 4-for-4 in field goals this year, so he's perfect on the year.
You know, Sioux Falls had a really, really nice run of kickers. Trevor Cook and some of those folks, of course, Justin Saravodka, who's up at State. Yep. Cook was at Miami of Ohio. They've turned out some serious kickers.
Well, Dorman has had some pretty good kickers years past.
And I have given up on telling you who's deep, because that's what Schuster is going to do every time. And coming up with that one once again was Justin Hatfield.
You know the speech I just gave the guys.
And so it will be first down here for the Roosevelt Rough Riders. Taryn Christian. Again, if you're just joining us, they go no huddle, but it's not necessarily a hurry-up offense. They can go quickly, or they can keep it slow. The throw, right side, Mulba through his hands.
Riders are without Chase Vinatieri, their leading receiver. It seemed to be an apparent shoulder injury on a catch early in the ball game. He has not yet returned.
Jake Bear is now the slot receiver in for Vinatieri, the 5'9", 175-pound junior. Christian will roll to his left. The throw caught by Hennings, and Hennings is gang-tackled out at the 47-yard line, but that's enough for a Sioux Falls Roosevelt first down.
Number two in receptions for the Riders, 27 catches coming into the game.
Clock stops, of course, as they set the chains. Now they are set, and the clock will roll. Nice camera work all weekend long by the crew from South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Christian will take that one himself. He'll pick up 3 yards right at the 50-yard line. It will be second down. Roosevelt with all three of their timeouts left. Lincoln with just one left on the board. Snap, the throw, the catch by Mulba. He'll turn it upfield and step out of bounds at a late flag. Let's see who that's going to be on. The ball right now is at the 37-yard line.
I got to think maybe Mulba is going to get called for the hand in the face.
I think so.
I mean, that is definitely a great matchup between Mulba, who is 6'3", and Keyshawn Britt, who's 5'11".
There it was. Wait a minute, there's some confusion here. There's some confusion. Yeah, there we go.
It is going to be against Roosevelt.
It was for that last little shove. There's a good look at the flag itself. And again, a good angle. If we could maybe show that just one more time there in the truck. They have been so great about this. Once we get the official ruling here.
Dead ball, personal foul against the offense, 15-yard penalty, first down.
Yes, it's a dead
take
ball
a look.
Foul.
Yep, take a look here. It will be on this last little shove. After that, then boom, that's where the personal foul comes. It was the extra shove by Mulba. He was complaining that the defender's hands were up around his collar.
And it should be a first down. They're getting the yard marker fixed. It is a first down because they did get the first down.
Right.
And then the dead ball moves the penalty back.
And so it will be first down and 10. Again, you see the time there. Just outside of 3 minutes. Christian fires. Caught. Complete to Hennings, and Hennings will have another first down, down to the 40-yard line. You see that arm strength of Taryn Christian. You haven't seen him get out and run, but Craig Christian, he's been under heavy pressure several times tonight. When he gets in the open field, he can really fly, but tonight Lincoln is going to let him throw the ball, but they're not going to let him run.
Christian has thrown to four different receivers. One guy he hasn't hit yet is Ryan Benson, number six.
So it will be first down, 10 yards to go. Christian keeps it himself, and there you can see that speed. He will burst forward for the first down, down to the 27-yard line. There have been times, Greg, where Christian has gotten out into the open field and he's run away from people.
Mm-hmm.
He can fly. So another first down for Roosevelt. Taryn Christian changing up the play at the line of scrimmage. Sees a matchup that he likes. The snap, here comes a blitz. He gets help, the throw towards the end zone, incomplete.
Tried to go to Jake Bear. Led him just a little bit too far.
That was what he changed it up to, and he saw that Bear was going to have man-to-man coverage.
You know, an injured Lincoln Patriot on the field.
Both these teams smacking each other around pretty good. Vinatieri has already gone out of the game.
And that is Alex Anderson.
Alex, the 5'10", 295-pound senior.
Remember, he got the fumble recovery earlier in the game.
Reminder that...
There you go.
Well, he's getting a little bit of help there coming off the field. But a reminder that if you're setting your DVR, and for those of you that own VCRs, whatever it may be, your recording mechanism... Sheryl Crow is scheduled to start at 10 o'clock. I'm not sure that's going to happen. There's been an awful lot of action in this one. I would say just roll your DVR right now, as a matter of fact. Catch the rest of this one. And then you're sure to catch all of Sheryl Crow in concert following tonight's game. So second down after the incompletion. Lincoln brings in Dylan Arntz as the backup defensive player, and there's a false start. The false start. Who's it going to go on? Roosevelt.
Yep. Six penalties on Roosevelt. Hey, let me recheck that here, Mike.
Dead ball, false start against the offense. 5-yard penalty, first down.
That would be the...
Second down.
Third penalty on Roosevelt, five on Lincoln.
So second down, 15 yards to go.
A lot of one-on-one coverage in this spread.
Mulba is letting Christian know that he's going to be open. Christian, can he get away from the rush to throw it? He can. Hennings with a nice catch. Tanner Hennings comes up with the catch. Mulba did have one-on-one coverage, but Christian had so much pressure.
That's a tough throw. He's going to his left, wants to throw right, being pressured.
Just gets enough on it. Hennings adjusts, comes up with the catch. So third down now and 4 yards to go. Clock rolling, going under a minute 40. All three timeouts. Christian wrapped up.
Matt Wagner with the tackle.
And a timeout going to be called by Roosevelt.
Well, your field goal kicker is not available.
Timeout, White, that's their first.
So what do you do? Are you going to try to go fourth and long, or do you try to bring Bauer again? Again, he missed an earlier field goal.
Chase Vinatieri is the kicker. He went out earlier, and...
I think if Vinatieri was available, they'd be trying the field goal.
Oh, yes, I agree. But again, the fact that he is not in the game,
Yeah,
and the toughest thing there was, even if Christian could have picked up even 2 or 3 yards, then it's an easy decision. Instead, what happened was he lost about 3 yards.
I wonder if that's Vinatieri there in the huddle with a big wrap around his shoulder. He's got his top off. That sure looks like Vinatieri in the huddle down there again. A wrap around his shoulder. There he is, right there.
Yep. Good look there, boys. Boy, you hate seeing that for Chase.
Kind of hard to kick that way, too.
Yes, it is. The good news is he is just a junior, so he does have another year next year. So it will be fourth down. 6 yards to go. Three wide right, two wide left.
Britt and Mulba, one-on-one coverage at the bottom of your screen, though.
The throw, the catch, and complete. Ryan Benson coming up with the catch. A huge fourth down conversion for the Roosevelt Rough Riders.
Well, he was looking for Benson the whole way. He was looking right.
Foss had good coverage, but Benson knew exactly where the sticks were, went up and got it. First down, Christian gets away, but only for a moment. Nice natural sound there as coming up with the hit for Lincoln was Taylor Salava. And Roosevelt will take another timeout.
Look, Salava's mouthpiece came out after this hit here. Right there.
Yep. And so it will be second down and 9 yards to go as Roosevelt uses another timeout.
Well, let's see. Rushing. 13 rushing attempts for Roosevelt. They've thrown the ball 15 times. Christian is 9 of 15 passing, 157 yards, one score. Minus 2 yards rushing for Roosevelt.
Don't forget that next weekend it's volleyball here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Craig, where are you going to be?
I will be in Aberdeen for the Class A tournament.
All of the tournament action is online at sdpb.org. That's all of the tournament action. Then third place and championship matches are on all three SDPB TV channels next Saturday night. But again, the great place to follow along with the arts and athletics. sdpb.org. Second down now, 9 yards to go. Christian, under pressure. Throwback screen, has a man. He'll waltz into the end zone. Touchdown, Seth Bjordahl.
Lincoln was coming with the double blitz. They were going to the left side, and they had the screen going the other way. And Bjordahl, nobody around him, and able to get into the end zone. His seventh touchdown of the year.
Every now and then, the perfect play call matches the perfect defense.
Here's Bauer again, the replacement kicker.
Snap, kick, good. So the Roosevelt Rough Riders will take the 24-20 victory. Or lead, excuse me.
12 plays. Almost 3 minutes.
Good luck at the congratulations being handed out to Bjordahl. Yeah, nice drive. 12 plays, 67 yards.
Roosevelt just had the screen set up just to the correct side. Just happened to be the opposite side that the blitz was coming in on Lincoln.
It's the horse head. It's back. We saw it yesterday with the Warner Band.
Insert punchline.
That's
here.
Right. We had a few. And as a matter of fact, if you would like to follow us on Twitter, perhaps we could share some of those. Where would they find you on Twitter, Craig?
At Craigmatic, M-A-T-T-I-C-K.
And you could find me on Twitter at Mike Henriksen, H-E-N-R-I-K S-E-N. Maybe we will share some of the punchlines that we had for seeing the horse head yesterday, but again, on Twitter. Now, I don't check my Twitter during ball games. Craig has it up, but you can also, of course, follow along and find us on Twitter at SDPB Sports. This one will be returned. Bell Hodge with some room to the 50. And into Roosevelt territory at the 42-yard line.
Oh, he found the right seam. Burst of speed. A great return. And this is going to give Lincoln a chance to get on the board before halftime. Watch that seam. He saw the seam, and then he burst into the third gear.
Makes the kicker miss there.
Ben Wimpfner was the one that put the brakes.
Roach, empty backfield. Has one man on a fly pattern. Goes the other way. Intercepted. Is that Atwood again? It is. Atwood with the interception. It's his second of the night. His first one on the third play of the game, he took into the end zone.
Boy, that's a tough pass across the field. Gave Atwood time to come on up and take it away from Dylan Bartow.
And Atwood with the creation of the turnover. So now let's see what Roosevelt can do. They've got one timeout left. Christian holds on to it. He's gobbled up there by Reed West. Reed just couldn't have played that much better.
Roosevelt will not use the timeout.
Christian taking his time. As a matter of fact, the Roosevelt coaches are heading down to the sideline. So they're going to maybe run one more play. Yep, they'll have to.
See, we'll do a fly pattern here. Nope.
Nope. Hand off to Bjordahl. He'll get outside. He'll get a block. He'll get out of bounds with 3 seconds left.
Big run by Bjordahl. Got a great block downfield, too, from Mulba. 2 seconds on the clock. It's too far for a field goal. Oh, there he stepped out way back at the 39.
All right, so it will be the final play here.
Nice camera work by the men and women of South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
So here we go, the last play of what has been an unbelievably entertaining first half of football. The rollout. Protection now breaks down. Christian steps up, fires. That's going to be intercepted, and that's how the game will end. Well, the half will end as Keyshawn Britt will come up with the interception on the final play of the game. At halftime, Roosevelt on top of Lincoln, 24-20. Oh my heavenly days! Well, I don't know about you guys, but I need a break. With Craig Maddock, I'm Mike Henriksen. Third member of our broadcast crew is Steve Toome. Steve is standing by on the sideline, and he's got an interview with the head coach of the Rough Riders, Kim Nelson. Steve?
All right, thank you here. Boy, I tell you what, Coach Nelson, we got to catch our breath here. What a first half of football. Started off great for your team.
Yeah, our defense made a huge play to start the game and got us excited. But Lincoln, you know, they fought back. We fought back. It's, you know, exactly what we predicted. I think both teams are fighting and making plays on both sides of the football. So I'm not surprised. I'm just hoping we can make it to the end.
I saw Chase Vinatieri on the sidelines here, out of uniform, obviously hurt. How does that change things down the stretch for your team?
Well, we're lucky to have a little bit of depth there. Jake Bear and Seth Bjordahl have been rotating with Chase at those running back positions. So as long as we don't have another injury, you know, we're going to be okay, I think. But we're going to miss Chase a lot. He's a playmaker. Obviously, he got hurt making a big play. And you know, we're back to our backup kicker. Isaiah's a sophomore and, you know, good kicker, but tough to throw him in a spot like that. But so far, so good.
Coach, Congratulations on making it to the Dome, and best of luck in the second half.
Thanks. Let's keep firing, all right?
Kim Nelson, head man for Sioux Falls Roosevelt. We'll take a timeout, come back with more. This is the Class 11 AAA Championship football game, South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Halftime of the 11 AAA Championship with Roosevelt leading Lincoln 24-20. Let's turn it over to the public address announcer here in the Dakota Dome, Greg Merrigan.
Good evening. Each year, the South Dakota High School Activities Association is proud to present its Distinguished Service Award to individuals who have made a significant contribution to the furtherance of high school activities in our state. The recipients of this award exemplify the very highest ideals of service to the association and the youth of our state. Ladies and gentlemen, it is with the deepest gratitude that the South Dakota High School Activities Association's Distinguished Service Award is being presented to one individual this evening. Wayne Carney, Executive Director of the Activities Association, is making the presentation. Tonight's Distinguished Service recipient is Julie Anderson. Julie is the Executive Director of South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Julie has worked for SDPB for over 24 years. She began working part-time in the development department while completing her BA in English and Journalism from South Dakota State University. Julie was named Executive Director in 1997. As Executive Director, she's responsible for operations of the State Public Broadcasting Network, which includes 9 TV and 11 radio transmitters, as well as 6 TV and 9 radio translators. Ladies and gentlemen, Julie Anderson. A resume for all the Distinguished Service Award recipients can be found in this year's State Football Championship program. Tonight's halftime entertainment is brought to you by the Vermilion Area Dance Organization with help from the Sanford Hospital Foundation. Tonight's routine is from their Level 4 dance team class, so please give a warm welcome.
Get you some halftime highlights and statistics of this 11 AAA championship. We're at halftime, 24-20, Roosevelt over Lincoln. More to come on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Championship event is brought to you in part by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Farmers Union Insurance, by SDN Communications, and by the Independent Insurance Agents of South Dakota.
With Steve Toome and Craig Maddock, I'm Mike Henriksen at halftime. Roosevelt on top of Sioux Falls Lincoln. By the way, just a note that that dance team was directed by South Dakota Public Broadcasting's own Stephanie Ristler, who you see on a regular basis here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting Airwaves.
We'll see her next Saturday night in Aberdeen at the state volleyball.
Sounds great.
She'll be helping out.
Craig, let's take a look at some statistics from this first half. First downs, Roosevelt with the advantage. Lincoln, the advantage on the ground, thanks mainly to the 80-yard touchdown run by Quintanilla.
And for Roosevelt, they were minus yardage until Seth Bjordahl kicked off a 30-yard run right near the end of the first half.
Meanwhile, total turnovers are at 2. Lincoln threw the pick 6. Roosevelt, one of those turnovers came on the last play of the half, the interception. Total yards pretty even. Time of possession, Roosevelt doesn't really care about that all that much. Pretty balanced, which you would expect from a 24-20 halftime score.
Individually for Lincoln, Caden Quintanilla, 12 rushing attempts for 101 yards. Isaiah Roach passing 5 of 11 for 80. 1 TD, 2 interceptions. And for Roosevelt individually, rushing, Seth Bjordahl, 3 for 30. Taryn Christian passing, 10 of 17, 171 yards, 2 scores, 1 pick.
Halftime at the Dakota Dome in Vermilion. We've crowned 6 champions. We've got another one to give the big hardware to. And we'll do that. Second half coming your way. You're on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Sports Championship is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank.
Got it.
Welcome back to the Dakota Dome in Vermilion. 24-20 is our score here at halftime. Coach, your team seemed like you blinked an eye and they were down by 10 points. Talk about their poise and resilience.
Yeah, I mean, they're doing a good job. We've been like that, you know, all year. I mean, it's not the first time we've been down all year either. And, you know, we got some fighters, but, you know, you can't spot them 10 and then, you know, expect a great result. But we came back and played hard, took a lead, and then, you know, made some mistakes. The biggest thing we have to do is finish. And what we mean by that is finish every block and finish every tackle. I mean, you know, their QB's good, and he's a little Houdini. He's pulling himself out of a lot of trouble. We just got to keep playing hard, because I don't doubt my boy's effort. But we just need to play through the whistle a little more and you know, and do it for the team and, you know, not themselves. And that's the type of guys they are.
Coach, thanks for your time. Good luck in the second half.
You bet. Thanks.
Aaron Beavers, the head man for the Lincoln Patriots. Let's send it back upstairs to Mike Henriksen and Craig Maddock.
All right. Thank you very much, Steve Toome. Let's take a look at some of the highlights. There were plenty of them, weren't there, Craig?
Right off the shoot. Isaiah Roach, pick 6. Atwood. Austin, his first of 2 picks on the night.
Meanwhile, Caden Quintanilla.
80-yarder, 101 yards in the first half for Caden.
And that came at a big time because Lincoln was on the ropes. Their defense had held Roosevelt to just a field goal.
And in the corner of the end zone, Dylan Bartow with the score.
The officials confer, rule it a catch and a touchdown.
Roosevelt said, let's go to that corner too. It was David Mulba.
Once again, then the throwback screen, Craig.
Touchdown for Seth Bjordahl. Bjordahl with 30 yards rushing in that first half.
And what we didn't show you were a pair of 41-yard field goals off of the foot of Taryn Schuster for Sioux Falls Lincoln. So very entertaining.
His longest field goal, by the way, from the year was 35. And so twice he has tied his longest field goal of the season.
A reminder that coming up tomorrow, join South Dakota Public Broadcasting for the premiere of the Gettysburg Story. 150 years later, America's greatest battle is recounted as you have never seen it before. Gettysburg Story provides a unique bird's eye view of Gettysburg National Military Park that comes up Sunday afternoon at 3 Central, 2 Mountain. I was very fortunate when I was a kid. I had the opportunity to visit the Gettysburg Battleground. And for those of you curious, Gettysburg, South Dakota is indeed named after Gettysburg of Civil War fame,
mm-hmm.
as a bunch of Civil War veterans actually settled in that area and named the town Gettysburg. Potter County, one of the teams that came up with their first state title this weekend. Congratulations to them, to Avon, to Bridgewater, Emory, Ethan, to West Central, and to Canton, as well as Pier. They are our sixth champions.
Yeah, I better mention the fine folks up at Holvin, too. With
Yep, absolutely.
With Potter County, the folks at Holvin, they're all excited.
You bet.
Their first trip to the Dome this year, and the co-op with Gettysburg, and they win the title in a wild one in the first day of the championship.
The former Greyhounds and the home of the Cathedral of the Plains. So at halftime, Roosevelt on top of Lincoln. Craig, Roosevelt, any adjustments?
Well, the biggest adjustment that they've already made, Chase Vinatieri, one of their leading receivers, out of the game, and their kicker. He will not return, and so Bauer will do the kicking, and they brought in Jake Baer to take over for him. That would be their biggest change. And for Lincoln, I think what Coach Beavers just said, just finish the blocking, finish the tackling. Hopefully they believe that Caden Quintanilla can light him up for a couple here in the second half.
Roosevelt won the opening kick, but they deferred, and so they will get the football to start this second half. With Steve Toom of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, Craig Maddock from Sioux Falls Sports Radio, KWSN. I'm Mike Henriksen from SportsMax Radio and our daily show, Calling All Sports. The last half of high school football in South Dakota for the year is underway. Popped up in the air, caught. 35-yard line is where Roosevelt will take over. Ben Wempner, the free safety, was up there, makes the catch. And it will be first down and 10 for Taryn Christian, the 6'2", 190-pound junior.
10 of 17 passing, 171 yards. Christian has carried the ball 11 times for 6 yards. Coming into the game, 2,200-yard passer, 1,000-yard rusher.
Of course, he has been sacked several times, and there's an interception, bringing it back. Large, living large, is Braxton as he's got the ball inside the 10-yard line.
Well, the Riders had the pick of the first series of the game against Lincoln. Now Lincoln takes the first pick from Taryn Christian. He didn't see Large at all. Tried to go to Mulba, and Braxton with a very nice return. And Patriots, excellent field position to start the third quarter.
Yordahl prevents the touchdown, and so here comes Lincoln. Isaiah Roach, the 6-foot junior, in his first start tonight at quarterback, hands it to Quintanilla, and he'll be hammered down by Trevor Janish. A pickup of a couple. Again, the reason that Isaiah Roach is in the lineup tonight, the 2-year starter, Connor Burchill, the senior quarterback.
He tore his ACL in the semifinal game. He's dressed. He's in pads. Just don't know if he'll be able to get in the game at all.
Power eye formation. Quintanilla dots the eye and finds the end zone.
That will be his 27th touchdown of the season. Just a basic dive right off that between the right tackle and guard, and Quintanilla. He's done that a lot this year.
As so often is the case, he followed fullback Matt Wagner. Kick is up, and it's good. Two plays, 8 yards, 36 seconds on that drive.
Well, we've had five turnovers now in this ball game. Three by Roosevelt and two by Lincoln.
And only one by Roosevelt was inconsequential. That was on the last play of the first half. Pass was intercepted. But again, this one just keeps going back and forth. Again, it was 35-28 when these two teams met earlier back in September. Lincoln built a three-score lead. Roosevelt scrambled back. But then Lincoln, getting the ball with 6.5 minutes left, maintained possession for the rest of the game.
Quintanilla, his 27th touchdown of the season, ties in with Jason Lieber, fourth all-time. Lieber did it in 1992.
And yes, that is the older brother of Ben Lieber, the longtime pro with the San Diego Chargers and the Minnesota Vikings. The kick is away.
Kicking it long this time.
Yep, Bear will take it.
Oh!
Boy, I hope he's all right. He came down right on his head.
Yeah, he was shaken up on that one. Well, did anybody hit him, or was he just kind of dive over somebody? It kind of looked like
I think he got spun up in the air. He was going up to avoid some contact, but contact came anyway. You heard Kim Nelson, and there's Kim coming out to take a look. You heard him talking about the fact that Bear and Briordal had done a nice job of rotating, filling in for Vinatieri, who was out of the game, but good to see him back up. Take a look here on the replay. He'll come through, and he got hit actually by his own man.
Well, Jake Bear again, yeah, you mentioned he's in for the injured Vinatieri, so who's going to come in for Jake Bear?
Vinatieri out with an injured shoulder, but here comes Taryn Christian.
Justin Mueller coming in as a wideout for Roosevelt.
Christian drops back, throws, finds Moba for the first down out to the 32-yard line.
Well, that's a nice battle between Moba and Keyshawn Britt. That's been a one-on-one matchup all night long, something that the Riders may want to take advantage of because Britt is 5'11", Mulba is almost 6'4". Appears to be a mismatch. Oh, that time they tried to go to Mueller. Justin Mueller trying to do just a basic down and in.
Tough spot for a sophomore to come in. 5'8", 165. Second down and 10 yards to go. Taryn Christian. Straight drop back. He'll go on the screen to Bjordal. Bjordal shakes a tackle. Gets to midfield where he is gang tackled just inside of Lincoln territory.
Wow, what a nice move by Bjordal. Had to make a couple of changes in direction. Sidestepped a couple of Patriots. Bjordal having a nice night tonight, rushing the ball. Yards after the catch here. Change direction there. Again there. Three times.
And good to see that Bear is coming back into the lineup. Jake Bear will return. He'll be lined up in that slot position. Lincoln changing some of their defensive personnel. Christian with the roll left. He'll look over the right side. Mulba overthrown.
See, there's that one-on-one coverage.
And again, it looked like maybe Mulba cut off his pattern just a little bit or a little bit. Christian and Mulba not quite on the same page there.
I don't think that's going to be the last time they try to connection.
I think you're correct on that.
There's Connor Burchill, number 14. He's been the starting quarterback at Lincoln, but unfortunately tore his ACL in that semifinal game.
The handoff goes to Mulva, and it fooled nobody. Leading the charge was Taylor Salava. So that will bring up a third down now and 9 yards to go. Lincoln with the lead. They trailed it 24-20 at halftime, but the interception by Braxton Lard set up another Quintanilla touchdown.
39th play of the game for Roosevelt.
The throw. Penalty flag, yep. The back judge just couldn't quite find the handle on it.
You got two flags, Mike. One at the line of two at the line of scrimmage, and then one downfield. This may offset.
You'll be hard-pressed to find an official who still has any laundry in his hip pocket. You'll have the pass interference down the field.
Probably will have a hold as well on the other side. Offset.
They were looking at downfield for Jake Bear.
Holding against the offense. Defensive pass interference against the defense. Penalties offset. Replace third down.
So the third down will be played one more time.
Okay, one of the eight.
Christian with Bjordahl on his right side. Straight drop. Steps up in the pocket and down he goes.
Caleb Rector, haven't called Caleb's name a lot. He's been a big factor in that defensive line for Lincoln. His fourth sack of the year, his first one tonight.
And so, after giving up some yardage, the defense for Lincoln comes up with a couple of big plays.
Yeah, those are the defensive ends meeting at the quarterback. Reed West was the other Lincoln Patriot there.
So, Taryn Christian to punt. Caden Quintanilla, the deep back. Another nice punt. Quintanilla will grab it and step out of bounds.
Total yards, Lincoln 255, Roosevelt 225.
So it will be first down, 10 yards to go, the ball at the 12-yard line.
Lincoln getting their yards, 175 yards on the ground, 80 yards passing.
Isaiah Roach will bring out the Lincoln offense. Patriots undefeated on the year. Roosevelt, just one loss, and that was to the Lincoln Patriots.
It was back in mid-September.
Quintanilla in motion. He'll take the handoff. Sweep on the right side. Get out near the 20. It will bring up second down and short. A nice gain on first down as you see the defense, or the offensive line, excuse me, of the Roosevelt Rough Riders there. Second down, 2 yards to go. 8 yard pickup for Quintanilla. Roach under center. This is where they've had their best offense tonight. Quintanilla follows Wagner. First down, Moore tries to get to the outside but is drugged down at the 30 yard line. Atwood came up with the tackle. Austin Atwood, who has a pair of interceptions, one for a touchdown.
Dalton Jones, the fullback, helping to spring Quintanilla. Dalton Jones, Matt Wagner, they've played that fullback slot. Dalton Jones wearing number 43.
And that's the man that's at fullback right now. Quintanilla dots the eye. The quick throw on the left side to Nas. He's got some running room. Cuts away from one man. Can he get there? Atwood will not catch him. From Isaiah Roach.
Nobody was covering him. Nobody on the line of scrimmage was lined up with Nas all alone.
Atwood has the angle, but Nas able to shake him and take it into the house. The kick. Good. Lincoln with 14 quick points here in the first 4 minutes of the second half has taken the 10-point lead.
Three plays, 88 yards, only took just over a minute. And again, that 70-yard touchdown run. I mean, that great read by Isaiah Roach, seeing that Nas was not even being covered. Nobody within 10 yards of Nas.
Trevor, another one of those outstanding all-around athletes. We mentioned it in the first half, from a very athletic family. His big brother Trey holds the all-time record for receptions in the state of South Dakota with 199, now playing at USF. Trevor also the grandson of the great Harvey Nas. Football kind of comes naturally to the Nas family. Harvey, the longtime coach out in Winter. And now back to receive is Mulba and Bear.
Officially, they made it a 69-yard touchdown catch for Trevor Nas.
They'll go back. And the busiest man on the kick return team for Sioux Falls Roosevelt is our man, Justin Hatfield.
Three touches tonight for
Justin.
Yes,
he has, for no yardage. But again, smart decisions by that young man each time. So first and 10 at the 30-yard line for this Roosevelt offense, which again, 10-point lead in this one.
That's Roosevelt, two plays.
Yeah, Roosevelt had a 10-point lead at one time.
Two quick plays.
Christian keeps it himself, picks up a few yards. Paul Thannell comes up from his safety position to make the tackle. Paul, 6'2", 172, and a junior. Craig, we touched on this a bit last night. It's always interesting to me how many nine-man fans don't like 11-man football, especially the bigger classes, and how many 11-man fans don't pay attention to nine-man. Listen, if you're watching terrific athletes, I don't care how many men are on the field. The throw to Mulba. Got it! What a catch, David Mulba!
There's that 6'3 frame going up high.
Double covered. Held on despite leading with his hand and shoulder to the ground. Christian, pressure, won't get away from it this time. So Christian, there's a loss of a couple. I believe that's sack number 6 maybe on the night, Craig?
I don't have that stat handy.
It's in that neighborhood, I know.
We are very close, though, to having the highest scoring, at least the old double-A records.
Christian turned right. He maybe should have turned left.
I suppose I shouldn't be looking at 11 double-A records anymore, should I?
Well, we're kind of confused about that because this is, all, after all, a new class of triple-A. Take a look here, Christian. He'll turn and turn right into Caleb Rector. Of course, coming from the other side was Matt Wagner, so he didn't have much room there either way. Third down, 10 yards to go. The throwback screen over the head of the intended receiver, Seth Bjordahl. And doing a nice job defensively there was Dylan Arntz. Dylan Arntz recognized what that play was, and he was not right on Bjordahl, but he was enough of a factor that Christian had to lob that ball high. And so now Taryn Christian will be on to punt And Quintanilla will be on to receive.
Let's see if he punts it towards the corner instead of right down the middle of the field.
He did a nice job the last time, putting Lincoln at the 12-yard line. That one also angling towards the sideline and out of bounds.
That's a good kick inside the 20.
And so what a burst it has been by Lincoln to start this second half. They're on top, 34-24. We're back after this timeout on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. A good look at Connor Burchill, who...
He wants to get in.
He does. I think he's been doing a little lobbying over there, matter of fact.
Oh, yeah. You know, I feel for him. You know, starting quarterback, you tear your ACL before the championship game, and we wish him the best.
Isaiah Roach has done a nice job in his stead. Quintanilla will line up in the Wildcat formation. He'll take the direct snap.
We've seen that, Mike.
Yep. Quintanilla sends a man in motion. Quintanilla will keep it, which is no big surprise there. He'll get it out to the 20-yard line, a pickup of about 3 on the play.
Quintanilla's 2 touchdowns tonight gives him 55 for his career. That is second all-time to Jason Lieber, who had 61 from 1990 to 92.
Well, the folks at SDSportsHistory.com better make sure they hang around, because this one's far from done.
We're going to have a new chapter of all these records going on.
Again, SDSportsHistory.com brought to you by the good folks at Shoneman's. And they'll go with the Wildcat here yet again. That time the handoff does go off to Bellage. He'll get outside, gets a nice block down the field, picks up the first down out at the 43-yard line.
Dylan Bartow got the nice block downfield, the wide receiver springing Bellage for, 20?
So first down, 10 yards to go. Lincoln trailed it 24-20 at halftime. A turnover and a touchdown.
If you're the Roosevelt Rough Riders, you got to see if you can make a stop here.
They haven't stopped Lincoln yet.
Down by 10.
Again, going full bore with the Wildcat formation. Hand off. Nope, Quintanilla will keep it. He's got nowhere to go. But he somehow gets through. Will you look at this? You have got to be kidding me.
Oh!
He will be marked out of bounds at the 2-yard line.
That would be a 54-yard run, and I thought he was done in the water twice. Kyle Olinger trying to get him, and then right there, Atwood able to get him out of bounds. Well, I don't know. The crowd just saw the replay too, but ball's going to be at the 2. Don't have instant replay in South Dakota.
Power eye formation. Quintanilla gets the ball. Muscles his way. He was about a 130, as Craig mentioned, as a freshman when he was first seeing playing time for these Lincoln Patriots. He is now muscled up to 175. He can't quite get into the end zone there. It will be second down and goal. There you go.
Yep. Way to go, camera.
Yep, excellent camera work. It's tough to tell whose foot is whose right there. Quintanilla will finish the deal. Caden Quintanilla.
That's his third touchdown of the night.
Lincoln looking for their 21st point of this quarter. They trailed it 24-20. A bad snap. Roach will roll out on the right side. He's under pressure and goes out of bounds. The extra point is no good. So 20 points in a row by the Lincoln Patriots, and they lead Roosevelt 40-24.
I think that was a planned fake. I thought I saw the words from Coach Beavers, why didn't you throw it or why didn't you get open? But things are running quite well for the Lincoln Patriots with a five-play, 82-yard drive.
Craig, we talked about it a little bit in that first half. Yeah, that's the thing. Taryn Christian, that's twice now that he's done a great job of punting the ball and pinning Lincoln back. But we talked about it in the first half. Of course, you can find South Dakota Public Broadcasting online on Twitter at SDPB Sports. And we would encourage you to do that. Of course, next weekend it is the volleyball tournaments, and of course we'll have basketball and wrestling and more. Where would people find you on Twitter, Craig Maddock?
Well, they can do that. There's SDPB Sports on Twitter. Follow me on Twitter at Craig Maddock, M-A-T-T-I-C-K.
And where would they find KWSN radio station?
KWSN Sports on Twitter.
And you can find me on Twitter at Mike Henriksen, H-E-N-R-I-K-S-E-N. And you can follow our daily sports show, Calling All Sports with Marco and Mike H, at Marco and Mike H. The kick is away. Grabbed. And return to the 30-yard line. That's been the average starting position tonight. As coming up with it there was Dan Larson, 5'11", 165-pound junior.
Quinton Ian now 20 carries, 188 yards, and three scores.
We said in the pregame, the kid's electric, as is Taryn Christian. And now Christian looking to bring his team back. He'll roll to the left side. Gets protection, throws, caught by Mulba. Mulba will come up with the catch for a first down.
Yeah, he's got six catches now for 119 yards. That was just a great roll, and Mulba really had to keep that one from hitting the turf.
Rolling out on the right side now. Caught. Turning up field is Ryan Benson. We haven't called his number very often tonight.
Second catch for Benson.
Pickup of about eight, just shy of Lincoln territory.
Christian has now used six different receivers. Benson with his second.
Once again, Chase Vinatieri out with a shoulder injury from earlier tonight. That one caught by David Mulba. He will go out of bounds. Enough for the first down. Wrestled out over there by Matt Wagner. First down for the Roosevelt Rough Riders. Coming right at you. Some great camera angles all weekend long. Our seventh championship game of the weekend on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Our thanks to the people in the truck, the sound crew, the camera operators, the ones hauling cables. They have just done a terrific job all weekend long. Craig Maddock, Steve Toom, Gary Ellenbolt, and I, we get the easy part. We just get to chat and watch football over the head of the intended receiver. He was looking for Jake Bear.
Braxton Large in coverage. That was a linebacker on Tanner Hannings. Hannings listed as a tight end, but basically just another wide receiver.
So it will bring up second down and 10. Christian sets, fires, caught. Again, every record tonight is a new record, but historically, these are starting to stack up pretty well. David Mulba, 6'3", 185, and a senior. He's having a night. Another first down.
Yeah, eight catches for 140 yards for Mulba.
Handoff goes to Seth Bjordahl. Fumble.
Roosevelt already with three turnovers.
The Lincoln Patriots come up with it, and Matt Wagner has the football. So Roosevelt, after marching down the field, take a look. Seth Bjordahl has the ball stripped. Rolling free. That was knocked loose by Taylor Salava. And Wagner wins the rugby scrum. Another turnover by the Roosevelt Rough Riders.
Isaiah Roach back in at quarterback.
And he'll hand it to Caden Quintanilla. The cutback. Oh, he was caught from behind. Nice play defensively by Trevor Janish.
He is now over 200 yards rushing. 203 on the night.
The clock stops here with the first down.
His season high has been 243.
What's he at now?
203.
He may have 243 by the end of the third.
Riders defensively got to come up with a stop. There are two scores and two-point conversions out of this.
Roach will keep it himself. Falls forward. Gets out to about the 38-yard line.
If you were going to compare this to the 11 AA records.
And again, this is new territory for us, folks, so Jason, just sail along.
Yeah, Jason Lieber had 283. In that championship game back in 92.
And that would be for all classes, correct?
Correct.
Because Vermillion was A at the time. Vermillion's one of those schools, they pretty much stayed A the whole time, haven't they?
Yes, they have.
I formation, Quintanilla looks for a hole. It was filled quickly by Kyle Olinger.
The 11 double A rushing record is David Sturdivant of Roosevelt when he had 233 yards.
I remember that game.
Roosevelt beat Washington that year for their second title.
S-T-U-R-D-E-V-A-N-T, come and see. A lot of people were just reading the back of his jersey that night.
Oh, Lincoln's got 445 yards of offense in this game.
Roach drops back, screen pass, caught, but not enough for the first down. A nice defensive stand there by the Roosevelt Rough Riders. And they will get the ball back as, for the first time in almost forever, we'll see the punt squad for the Lincoln Patriots.
Yeah, that'll be Trevor Nas going back to punt.
Nas on fourth down and five. Again, Roosevelt should get this in pretty good field position. Pressure. Nas gets it away. Good punt. Fielded. Bjordahl. Or excuse me, Atwood. Atwood to the 40. Holds on to the ball out of bounds at the 42-yard line. So a nice job by Austin Atwood.
Yeah, he's done a great job returning tonight. Of course, he's got a couple of picks as well, defensively.
One for a touchdown. And so here comes Taryn Christian. Turnovers have plagued the Roosevelt Rough Riders. Probably the last play of this third quarter. Roosevelt led it 24-20 at halftime. Christian drops back, fires, caught. Mulba, clock will stop. as they'll set the chains, because that is enough for a first down.
Yeah, that was just a basic timing pattern for Mulba. Goes down quickly 10 yards, stops, turns around, and ball was already on its way when he was just getting ready to turn around.
And the clock will start, tick off 1 second, and we're done. We've got another 12 minutes of football in the South Dakota high school football season. And we'll bring it to you when we come back after this timeout on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. With Steve Toome from South Dakota Public Broadcasting, Craig Maddock from Sioux Falls Sports Radio, KWSN. I'm Mike Henriksen from Sports Max and Calling All Sports. Quarter number four underway. Ball falls incomplete. Intended for Ryan Benson. Coverage over there by Levi Foss.
Through three quarters, Mike. Lincoln, 444 yards of offense. Roosevelt, 314.
So second down, 10 yards to go. Taryn Christian drops back, finds his man. That's Bjordahl on the screen. Gets a nice
fumble
break. He fumbled again. Lincoln has the football. If they rule that a fumble, Lincoln is on it. Levi Foss has the ball, and the Lincoln Patriots will get another turnover. Seth Bjordahl is arguing that he was down. Take a good look. Here comes Bjordahl on that screen that he scored on earlier today.
Did you guys get the game out?
There's the ball. It's out.
Yep, came out. It was Reed West. Knocked it out.
You heard one of the coaches on the sideline there under our natural sound asking the officials if they got together. There was no need. They had it right. First down, 10 yards to go. Roach, Quintanilla hesitates.
That was a great tackle by Kirby Hora.
Very much so.
Haven't called Kirby's name in a while.
So a loss of a yard on the play. Fourth quarter underway. Yet another turnover by the Roosevelt Rough Riders. That has really turned the tide in this game.
Kirby Hora with his fifth tackle of the night.
I formation. Swing pass, Nas makes one man miss and then knocked down hard at the 45-yard line. For those of you joining us on South Dakota Public Broadcasting, waiting for No Cover, No Minimum and Cheryl Crow, where the heck you been?
Nas.
You're missing a dandy right here at the Dakota Dome.
Getting by Jordan Holfer and then getting another 6 yards. This is a big third down. Ryder D wants a stop.
They need a stop. Clock rolling. I formation. Dalton Jones is the fullback. Quintanilla dots the I. Left side. First down. Into Roosevelt territory at the 49-yard line. Again, Cheryl Crow will be coming up following the completion of this game. But boy, oh boy, we've got an exciting fourth quarter going on here. It was 24-20 Roosevelt at halftime. The first half went back and forth. Big plays, exciting plays, electric plays, defensively and offensively. But turnovers have led to more points for Lincoln. They have scored 20 successive points. Hand off on the counter goes to Adam Belhodge around the left, the spin move, the dive. He'll come up shy of the first down. Trevor Janish was able to get a hold of his ankle.
Well, that left side of that Lincoln line, Kyle Sim, Mike Van Velhuizen, just taking the defensive front of Roosevelt and moving him out of the way. easy 8 yards for Belhaus.
We talked in the pregame that both of these offensive lines go with speed, but the offensive lines go with size, but the defensive lines go with speed. Well, so far, the Lincoln offensive line has been winning things at the point of attack tonight. Hand off, Quintanilla. And now this, Craig, enough for a first down. Craig, you saw this earlier this year when these two teams played. Lincoln has just gone into the mode where they're perfectly happy with 4, 5, and 6 yards of crack, eating up that clock.
Yep, absolutely right. Going to the left, Lucas Heitkamp in at fullback now for Lincoln. Lincoln, they've rushed 35 times tonight, 371 yards. This will be the 50th play of the night for Lincoln.
And I imagine that between Jones and Wagner, they've gotten tired doing some blocking for Quintanilla. So it's nice to have Heitkamp in there. Another pickup of 7 yards on first down for this Lincoln Patriot. The offensive line, Derek Peters, the 6'2", 242-pound junior. Drew Peters, the 236-pound junior. Levi Rosenboom, the center, 265 and a senior at 6 feet tall. You mentioned Kyle Sim, the sophomore, and Mike Van Veldhuizen, the senior. They have just done a terrific job tonight.
Quintanilla now 26 carries for 221 yards.
Fake, Roach, bootleg, left side. He'll pick up maybe a yard. It will bring up third down, but again, wisely, he stays in bounds and will keep that clock rolling. Plus, he was real handy to be right there by Coach Aaron Beavers so he can get the call for the next play. Again, Lincoln trailed at 24-20 at halftime. Now, trying to eat some clock.
Roach is 7 of 13 passing, 86 yards.
Both of these teams with 3 timeouts left. Lincoln not the least bit interested in stopping the clock. Handoff Wagner. Wagner will not get the first down. So now if you are Lincoln, you had your best fullback in there carrying the ball. Matt had a terrific run earlier tonight that was waved off by a holding penalty.
I think it's a little bit too far for a field goal here for Schuster, so you go for it on fourth down.
No point punting. And frankly, you don't want to give this ball back. Yes, Roosevelt has been turning the ball over. But as we were talking during the break, Roosevelt could also score on 3 out of their next 4 or 5 plays.
Well, they're going to take a timeout or a penalty here. Lincoln is, they're letting the time go down. They're taking a timeout.
Going to talk this one over.
Well, if they were going to try a field goal, it would be a 45-yarder. And Terrence Schuster,
he's got a pair of 41-yarders tonight.
Which I think he could hit from 45, watching him in practice before the game. I have a feeling they're going to go for this. They can take another 2 minutes off the clock if they get the first down.
We'll take time to remind you that in 1863, Abraham Lincoln proved himself a master of a new frontier with his high-tech command center, the War Department Telegraph Office. It was America's first situation room. On the 150th anniversary of his famous Gettysburg Address at Lincoln, a major turning point in American history. That comes up the dawn of the information age, Tuesday at 8 Central, 7 Mountain on SDPB.
Caden Quintanilla, 1,865 yards this year. That's ninth all time for a season.
So on fourth down, offset power eye. Give it to your all-everything running back and watch him pick up the first down inside the 20 to the 17-yard line. The clock continues to roll.
I know we talk a lot about Caden Quintanilla, but you just did it too, Mike, mentioning that offensive line, springing that hole for him. And this is a very good defensive front line for Roosevelt.
Also, we mentioned them a couple of times, but they bear repeating. Dalton Jones, Matt Wagner doing such a great job at fullback. Now they're both in at fullback for Quintanilla. He can choose which way he wants to run. That time, the Roosevelt defense swarms him. A loss. Nope, just no gain. He did get back to the line of scrimmage, but again, that clock continuing to roll.
Roosevelt has any chance, they have to stop Lincoln on this.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Kim Nelson opting to save his timeouts until the proper time. We've seen it a lot in the NFL and college and high school, and that is clock management seems to have become a lost art. But Kim is one of those guys. He's on top of this. We talked to him on Calling All Sports, our daily sports talk show. And now a timeout by Lincoln. They will spend their second timeout. We talked with Kim on Calling All Sports, our daily sports talk show, and he and folks like John Stegemeyer, a lot of staffs, they've got an actual chart. They will tell you exactly where the ball, what the down and distance is, how much time, all of those types of things. So he knows that he can go ahead and keep these in his hip pocket, and now Lincoln is the one who actually stopped the clock here on second and 10.
One more note on Caden Quintanilla. In the first matchup of the year when these two teams played back in mid-September, Quintanilla had 243 yards against Roosevelt that night. Well, right now he's got 232, so he's had 475 yards rushing against Roosevelt in their two games.
My goodness. Hey, while we've got a chance, let's thank the good folks at South Dakota Public Broadcasting, Julie Anderson, Larry Rohr, Bob Bussey, Brad Van Osdell. If I start naming everybody, I'll leave somebody out, but all of the folks who have worked so hard this weekend, and not just this weekend, it's a lot of work putting on these statewide events and bringing them to your living room or your iPad or your phone. And I want to thank the folks at Public Broadcasting for the great job they do in the office, behind the scenes, and in the truck. Handoff, Wagner. He'll get down near the 10-yard line. It'll bring up third down, and the clock will go under 5 minutes to play. Mark it at the 12. Third down. And Craig, if this clock got to 4 minutes and Lincoln got a field goal, I think they'd be beside themselves with glee.
Yes, they would. Absolutely. That makes it officially a three-score game. Because right now it's still two touchdowns, two extra points. Two-point conversions.
Roach. Handoff. Quintanilla. Inside the 10. Down to the 6. A first down for Caden Quintanilla.
Certainly been watching some history tonight. If Quintanilla scores one more touchdown, he will tie the all-time mark of 29 touchdowns in a season. Gannon Moore of Lincoln did it in 08, Mitch Breen of Wagner in 09, and Mike Gallagher of West Central in 07.
The clock at 4 minutes, it's first down and goal. Quintanilla marches into history. He uses the block on the right side, and off he goes, giving Lincoln a 46-24 lead. Schuster is on for the extra point. It's up and good. A drive for the ages and a performance unlike one that we've seen in quite some time. South Dakota Public Broadcasting bringing it to you tonight, and we're back after this timeout. With Steve Toom and Craig Maddock, I'm Mike Henriksen. Craig, the defense for Lincoln has done a terrific job coming up with turnovers, but the easiest way to keep Roosevelt from scoring is not to give him the ball. And that drive by Lincoln was epic.
Almost 8 minutes long, 13 plays. One more note on the 29 touchdowns of the season by Quintanilla. Ties Gannon Moore. Gannon Moore did it when Lincoln won the title in 08.
And don't forget, there was one extra game that year. This year, the teams are playing.
Two.
There were two extra games that year. That's right.
Basically, 11 AAA this year. They lost one regular season game, and they lost a playoff game.
Very true. So that was set in 13, and this is game number 11. The kick is away.
It'll
bounce up in the air. And recovering it, fortunately, for Roosevelt.
Running back up at Southwest State.
Terrific running back at Southwest State. Anthony Meilenberg was on that team. Anthony still getting it done as a redshirt senior now for Dakota Wesleyan. Anderson was on that team. They had some players in 08. But boys, they got some players on this team too. So Taryn Christian. The drop back. The throw. The drop. It was caught, but knocking it away was Keyshawn Britt.
Now Keyshawn has been on David Mulba all night long. That's been a tough assignment.
And Keyshawn comes up hobbling. I believe that's a cramp. The way that he's trying to stretch himself out. Yep. Keyshawn is hobbling on that far sideline.
Staying in the game.
If I'm Christian, I'm throwing it to Mulba right now because Britt can hardly move. Christian instead will turn it upfield and run left side. Oh, my.
That was a big, big hit.
Both these teams have been so solid tonight. So many of these players know each other.
Taryn Christian, 15 carries for 1 yard. He is 19 of 32 passing for 290.
And I was right, 6 sacks for that Lincoln defense tonight, 9 total tackles for loss. The throw caught by Benson. That's Tanner Hennings.
His fourth catch of the night.
Roosevelt obviously in a hurry here. But again, that drive by Lincoln put this one on ice. Christian, he'll turn it upfield. And he'll have enough for the first down past the 45-yard line.
Mike, I can't wait to see how many of the kids we saw tonight are going to be playing next year somewhere on a Saturday afternoon.
I think there's going to be plenty of them. And a lot of these kids are juniors, too. Taryn Christian is a junior. Chase Vinatieri, fortunately, is a junior, so he'll have his senior year to come back.
Benson is a junior.
After being injured earlier tonight with a shoulder issue, the throw on the outside for Benson, tipped away. Levi Foss with the good coverage. Yeah, Hunter Tebben on that offensive line, Sam Denovan and Grant Schmidt are all juniors on the offensive line for Roosevelt. Meanwhile, predominantly seniors. Only 2 junior starters defensively for Lincoln, Braxton Large and Paul Tannell. The incompletion stops the clock.
That's going to be movement there on Roosevelt.
Meanwhile, offensively for Lincoln, Drew and Derek Peters are juniors. Kyle Sim, just a sophomore. He's going to be fun to watch.
False start against the offense. 5-yard penalty. Repeat second.
Of course, Isaiah Roach, who came out and in his first start tonight, he had gotten playing time during the season, but his first start at quarterback His first pass is a pick six going the other way from Austin Atwood, who takes it to the house. But Roach is a junior, and Roach has gotten nothing but better as the night has moved on here. Christian, down he goes. Sack number seven.
Reed West. That Lincoln D is giving Christian a lot of pressure tonight. That front seven has been causing problems for everybody in AAA this year.
Sioux Falls Roosevelt led this game 10 to nothing just a minute and a half into the game. But Sioux Falls Lincoln showing incredible resiliency. Christian on the run, under pressure, flings it, caught, Mulba. Big pickup on third down, that'll bring up fourth. And the clock gonna continue to run.
When Mulba's athletic, isn't he?
Oh, he's been fun to watch. Is that 10 catches now for him?
10, 169 yards. Fourth down.
Fourth and nine. The throw, incomplete. That one hit. That hit our sound guy.
And Lincoln's going to be able to run out this clock. And I know it's a brand new class, but Aaron Beavers now is going to be a coach that will have won titles in three different classes. Gregory in 1998 in class 11B. 2008 in 11AA, and of course this year 11AAA.
And by the way, let's tip our hat to Kim Nelson, not only on the incredible season that the Roosevelt Rough Riders have had and the program that he has built over there, but also Kim knew that coming back was pretty much impossible. He kept his timeouts in his hip pocket. A show of sportsmanship.
There's Connor Burchill out there for Lincoln.
Wonderful to see Connor Burchill. Let's get to him now as the senior quarterback who tore his ACL last week is going to see time in a state championship game, even if it's to take a knee. Again, both these programs, so much respect for each other, their staffs, our friends. There you hear the Lincoln fans cheering Connor Burchill.
Waiting for the play clock to go down. 5, 4, 3.
Yep. Yeah,
shouldn't have to run another play, Mike. Caden Quintanilla, 30 carries, 244 yards, 4 touchdowns.
And so now they will start the play clock. You are correct. The Lincoln Patriots will knock off Roosevelt twice this year on their way to an undefeated season and their second state title. Congratulations to Aaron Beavers and the staff. You are 11 AAA champions. What a performance it was tonight, Craig. Lincoln down 10 to nothing, a minute and a half into this game.
They put up 500 yards of offense tonight. The defense holds Roosevelt to 35 yards rushing. 322 yards passing for Roosevelt. A lot of that, though, was trying to catch up.
And so the Lincoln Patriots complete the undefeated season. Of course, it always takes a little longer for the big schools to shake hands. Got a few more bodies out there than, you know, Hamlin and Avon. There you see, there's a good look at both teams. Again, so much respect for each other, for the programs.
A lot of these kids played junior football with one another.
Very much so.
Just a great... great show of sportsmanship. Roosevelt, this was their fifth appearance. Lincoln, just their second appearance in the 32 years of the high school football playoffs.
And while we're at it, one more time, let's thank Dan Gensler, along with Dave Camp and SDSportsHistory.com, which is brought to you by Shoneman's. You can find history at SDSportsHistory.com. It is a wonderful website, but our thanks to Dan for keeping us on top of so many of these, this factual information, the historical information down here at the Dakota Dome. He has been a great help behind the scenes.
By the way, for Sioux Falls Lincoln, they will have their welcome home celebration 3 o'clock tomorrow at Lincoln High School.
Did you just find that on Twitter? Or did they let you know that?
They had a source.
Oh, okay. All right.
Little birdie told me that, that if they won, we were supposed to let them know.
You are well dialed in, my friend. Of course, next weekend, it's volleyball. All three classes online at sdpb.org. All three classes, all 3 days. And then Saturday night, the third place and championships will be on SDPB Television 1, 2, and 3. And so finally, the teams are just about wrapping up, shaking hands. There you go. Good luck at Kim Nelson and Aaron Beavers. It's time to give away some hardware. Let's go ahead and send it over to our PA announcer, Greg Merrigan, bringing you the post game.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I direct your attention to the center of the playing field to present the awards to the 2013 runner-up and championship teams for Class 11-3A football is Jason Untermark of Aberdeen Central, representing the Board of Directors of the South Dakota High School Activities Association. Assisting with the team awards are representatives from the Activity Association's corporate partners, Trig Odney from Sanford Health, Brian Hermson of Farmers Union Insurance, and Sergeant First Class Nicholas Cousinbury from the South Dakota Army National Guard. And to accept the runner-up trophy, they finished the year with an outstanding record of 9-2. Head coach Kim Nelson, Sioux Falls Roosevelt. And now to accept the 11-3A championship trophy, their second state title. They finished the year with a perfect record of 11-0. Head coach Aaron Beavers, the Sioux Falls Lincoln Patriots. The individual awards. Each year, the members of the media covering the football playoffs select a Joe Robbie MVP in each of the championship games. To present the Joe Robbie MVP is Nikki Peters, representing the Vermilion Chamber of Commerce. Our Robbie recipient rushed 30 times for 244 yards and four touchdowns from Sioux Falls Lincoln, Caden Quintanilla. The South Dakota High School Coaches Association selects an outstanding lineman and an outstanding back in each of the championship games. The coaches have selected Levi Roseboom of Lincoln High School as the outstanding lineman in this championship game. And the coaches have selected Caden Quintanilla of Lincoln High School as the outstanding back in this championship game. And this is welcome home for the Lincoln Patriots on Sunday at 3 o'clock in the Lincoln High School gym. Again, a welcome home for the Lincoln Patriots on Sunday at 3 o'clock in the high school gym. Both squads will go to their respective end zones for an official team photo. Following that, fans may join their teams on the field.
Aaron Beavers, congratulations on the championship. You're down by 4 points at halftime, but your defense was stellar in the second half.
Yeah, they sure were. I mean, that's one heck of an offensive team that Roosevelt had. And, our defense stepped up, and we talked after half. We've been down before, we just keep chopping wood. You know, we just got a bunch of hard workers, and that's what the boys did. And, they showed up to play. We talked at half about, a couple things, but not much other than just finishing plays. And in the second half, we finished plays. We not only finished the defense plays, we finished offensive plays.
Your offensive line really dominated the line of scrimmage. Tell us about these young men.
They're awesome. They are a tight-knit group, hardest workers I've had in my coaching career. And, we do lose two of them, but we got some other guys that the other guys that will be coming back are going to lead like those two seniors did with Mike Van Veldenhuizen and Levi Rosenboom. And they've just, laid such a great foundation for, our big boys, we call them. And, Lincoln has been known for that. And, we got some back in the wood shop that we're going to be using in the future.
Coach, thanks for your time. Congratulations on the championship.
You bet. Thanks for the coverage. Appreciate it.
Thank you. And while we got a moment here, we've got Caden Quintanilla, the Joe Robb MVP. Congratulations. How does it feel to be a state champion?
It's amazing. I've worked my whole life for this moment. I worked my whole life with these guys every single down, every single time. We had the ball. We knew we were going to win this game. We played our hearts out, and we did it.
Now, you guys fell behind pretty early. Was there any panic in that huddle?
No, we rallied around Isaiah. We knew he was young coming in. He wasn't having a lot of experience. We had confidence in him, and Connor was, on his back a lot and, helping him read the defenses, tell him what to read. And we just rallied around him, and our offensive line really stepped up the second half.
I want to take you back to a moment. You're in the victory formation. Connor Burchill is out there. Could you hear the fans chanting his name?
Yes, I could. It was amazing. I was tearing up for him because I love him so much, and it's so sad to see that he couldn't help us win this game, but, he was there for us emotionally, and that's all he could do for us.
Congratulations on the championship. I'll let you go celebrate with your team.
Thank you very much.
What a win for the Lincoln Patriots, your 11 AAA champions. We'll be back in just a moment. This is the High School Football Championships on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Welcome back to the Dakota Dome in Vermilion. The Sioux Falls Lincoln students and parents out celebrating with the Sioux Falls Lincoln Patriots, who scored 27 points in the second half and shut down Roosevelt. Let's take a look at some of the statistics from that first half, or from that game tonight, Craig.
Wow. 502 total yards for Lincoln, 416 rushing. Meanwhile, Roosevelt, only 35 rushing yards. But the five turnovers for Roosevelt was the key.
That was the difference.
No doubt about it.
The turnovers and the high number of sacks, that's one of the reasons you figure sacks into the rushing yards, too. Taron Christian was just completely thwarted in that second half. Here's the first throw of his, and it is large. Coming up with the interception, he'll take it all the way down to the inside the 10-yard line. And then guess who? It's Caden Quintanilla into the end zone.
Four scores for Caden tonight.
Speaking of that, take a look at this run. He gets loose again.
Got down to the two.
And was ruled out of bounds, but he did finish it off with that run. Yeah, 54 yards on that previous pickup. Lincoln fans enjoying the devil out of it. The throw, Bjordahl with the catch and the fumble. And Wagner came up, or no, can't remember who came up with that fumble, but it was a fumble. Bjordahl turned it over. That ends up in a touchdown run for Caden Quintanilla.
That was his fourth of the night.
And the Lincoln Patriot faithful celebrating. They get the big trophy. The first ever 11 AAA championship goes to the Lincoln Patriots. We've had a heck of a week here at the Dakota Dome, and we're going to wrap things up when we come back after this final timeout on South Dakota Public Broadcasting, because we got to make way for Sheryl Crow. Seven champions crowned in South Dakota high school football. Sioux Falls Lincoln, the final one. They pick up the 11 AAA championship. We want to take another moment to thank all of the men and women who have been behind the scenes for seven games. It gets to be a chore and an awful lot of work, but whether they're running a camera or they're working on the sound or they are back in the front office booking motel rooms, whatever it may be, we really appreciate the entire cast and crew. Like I said earlier, Steve Toom, Gary Ellenbolt, Craig Maddock, and I, we get the fun part because we just get to watch football and talk. So we greatly appreciate the crew. Thanks so much to the City of Vermilion. They do a wonderful job. Craig, let's do this again next year. What do you say?
I'm ready.
All right. Listen, we're going to get out of the way because, let's face it, all we want to do is have some fun. And Sheryl Crow is coming up next. From the Dakota Dome in Vermilion, for Gary Ellenbolt, Steve Toom, Craig Maddock, I'm Mike Henriksen. Thanks so much for joining us. We'll talk again soon.